A Napa guy knows the only way you'd give a freshly minted driver a brand new car is if he promises to never drive it. Instead, let him grind the gears and knock over the neighbor's mailbox in something a little more suited to his skill level. And with over 400,000 parts and a little Napa know-how, he can safely drive something that's nearly as old as he is. It's not perfect, but it's perfect for him. That's Napa know-how.
Blog Talk Radio.
This is True Capitalist Radio. True Capitalist Radio.
I am your host, the man they call Ghost.
The badass of business.
Give him capitalism or give him death.
That's it. Period.
Broadcasting from his Skyline Office Studios in beautiful downtown Austin, Texas.
You sound fruitier than a box of Fruit Loops, for Christ's sake.
And now, he'll take it from here. Your host, the prognosticator of prognosticators, the man they call Ghost.
What's going on, folks? Man, just barely made it up in here. And thank you for tuning in with me to another edition of True Capitalist Radio. And, of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. This is episode number 83. For all the folks that are keeping track, believe it or not, yesterday, Sunday, we had a special edition of True Capitalist Radio, a special anti-Mother's Day edition of True Capitalist Radio. And let me tell you something right now. That was definitely a special edition. If you missed it, it was episode number 82, and you need to go back in the archives at blogtalkradio.com/ghost and relive the memories that we had on that evening, for Christ's sake. It was great. Anyway, back to business, folks. We're kicking back, chilling like some insane villains. I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. Before we get into the broadcast, I would like for everybody to please retweet the broadcast, go to the social network sites, the blogs, the forums, and spread it around. Spread it around like a wildfire. And let everybody know that True Capitalist Radio is in effect in the house. And let's see if we can get some milky liquors up in here that actually have some substance to put on the debating table. Anyway, let's get through the markets, folks. As a matter of fact, if you were in the markets, you were actually making a little bit of money today. Yeah, believe it or not, unless you were, unlucky to have a company that didn't meet up to the street's expectations for earnings. But for the most part, we saw some bounce backs. And let's just go ahead and go over through that. Let me go ahead and get through it so we can take your calls. There's a lot of things to talk about today. It's Monday. Blue Monday. Blue Monday. Anyway, let's get to the markets. Dow Jones Industrials closes out today at 12,684.70, an increase of 45.94 points, a percentage increase of 0.36%. S&P 500 closes out today at 1,346.29 points, an increase of 6.09 points, a percentage increase of 0.45%. NASDAQ closes out today at 2,843.25 points, an increase of 15.69 points, a percentage increase of 0.55%. As you can see, folks, it was some modest gains, but if you happen to be holding some of these key stocks that went up the roof, you know as well as I know, you were making cake. And let me tell you something, it was a good day over here. Anyway, let's go ahead and go to the commodities, not to mention that the stocks rebounded, the equities markets rebounded, but commodities rebounded. I mean, it looked like last week the complete and utter bottom. It looked like a goddamn free fall last week in the commodities markets. Today we're having bottom feeders. They're coming in. They're bringing back the costs of all kinds of commodities. Let's get through those. Let's go to the Brent crude futures. And, of course, for all you ass clowns that don't know what Brent crude is, it's the oil that's shipped off to Europe and Asia. All right? I mean, I know I keep saying that. Everybody always gives me crap every time I say that. But, you know, some people don't know what the hell they're talking about. Anyway, it closes out today at $116.13, an increase of $7 today. $7 increase on Brent crude futures, an increase of 6.41%. Jesus Christ, I'm stumbling over my own tongue like Zsa Zsa Gabor on her deathbed right now, for Christ's sake. Gasoline futures are up $9.25. Heating oil futures are up $12.79, a percentage increase of 4.49%. Natural gas futures are down 4 cents. And WTI sweet crude, you know, right when I was, showing a little glimpse of hope, you know, right when I thought that, you know, WTI sweet crude was going to go down, we were going to see a set decrease in gasoline prices and energy prices and that sort of thing, WTI sweet crude raises up the ash today. I mean, have you seen the prices? It increased $5.78, a percentage increase of 5.95%, closing out today at $102.96 per barrel of WTI sweet crude. All right? WTI sweet crude, for Christ's sake, man. I mean, you know, right when the media is sitting over here trying to tout, oh, yeah, there's going to be a penny a decrease next week in gasoline prices because of all the decreases in shut your stinking smelly hole. It's going back up once again, for Christ's sake. I mean, good God. Let's go up. Let's go to the agricultural futures, shall we? We got canola futures up $8.10 today. We've got cocoa futures falling out flat. I mean, you know, no change today in cocoa futures, believe it or not. Coffee futures continue their descent. They're down 15 cents. Corn futures are up $21.25, an increase of 3.10%. Now, of course, once again, corn is going up, and I hate to keep reiterating this, all right? I hate to keep reiterating this, but the reason that this goddamn corn keeps going up is because of this ridiculous warped government subsidy that America keeps giving these farmers and giving all these other industry insiders of turning corn into ethanol. Yeah, we're actually burning food so that we can fuel the cars and gas guzzlers of America. And I don't know what part of the country you're at, folks, but here in Texas, we actually have these stupid-ass pumps that actually pump out corn ethanol all across Texas. I kid you not. I kid you not. Of course, you have to have one of these corn ethanol-based cars, vehicles. But believe it or not, folks, America, under our current corn production, we're burning 40% of the corn we produce so that we can refine it into goddamn ethanol and put it in our goddamn gas guzzlers. And what makes me sick is that, you know, we see these increases in not only commodities, but we see these increases in everything, especially corn. And people are asking these questions. Why? Why is this happening? Our government is doing it. Do you understand? This is government interfering with private enterprise and forcing private enterprise to utilize the production of corn, 40% of it, folks, you can look it up for yourself, to refine it into corn ethanol so that we can have an alternative energy source to petroleum. And let me explain this also, that you can look this up for yourself, that they found out that corn ethanol actually burns dirtier than petroleum. So, you know, welcome to America. You understand what I'm saying? This is why we're seeing increases in corn futures, all right? Disgusting. Let me go ahead and continue on, shall we? We got cotton futures down 16 cents. We've got wheat futures up $40.50, all right? an increased percentage of 4.63%. How convenient. How convenient. Everything that we eat, how convenient, right? Everything we eat going up again, huh? Oh, yeah, hey, this is just great, isn't it? Yeah, it just makes me sick. It makes me sick to my stomach, you know? And this is government's fault. I know people are sitting over here blaming this, blaming that. It is the merging of private enterprise and government is what's causing this disgusting display of increase in food. Food! Now, don't get me wrong. I mean, there's an aspect of this of emerging markets coming out of the international community increasing demand. But let's be honest. I mean, a lot of this has to do with warped policies implemented by governments. Anyway, sugar is up 49 cents, an increase of 2.39% today. Soybean futures are up $9. We've got oat futures up $11 and, $11 even. Once again, another commodity that we eat up 11 bucks, oat futures, an increase of 3.24%. Soybean oil futures are up 53 cents, and wool saw a sell-off after, dramatic increases throughout the weeks. It was down $10. Now, you know, even though the CME group, all right, CME, which is the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, even though they raised the margin requirements for one to be able to trade in the metals markets, and we saw massive just sell-offs last week. People were like, what the hell's going on in the metals markets? Everything's selling off. And I even said last week that, first of all, this is an artificial attempt at trying to, you know, somehow keep the metals market down in price so that we as American people can believe that the currency that we possess in our pockets is actually having more buying power than it actually has. This is all smoke and mirrors, folks, all right? This is all smoke and mirrors. Our monetary policy is completely warped. Fortunately for us that everybody else in the world's monetary policy is more screwed up than ours. But at this point in time, the reason that we're seeing artificially, price gouging, or not price gouging, but price decreases, excuse me, artificially price decreases in the metals market is because this merging of Big Brother government with the financial industry. You know, this is not something that I have, kept in the closet here, all right? I mean, the government has merged with private enterprise, and anybody who doesn't believe me, why don't you take a look at Goldman Sachs? Why don't you take a look at all the government bailouts of all these financial industries, not just here in America. I mean, this was happening in Europe. This is continuing to happen in the European Union. It is just an utter disgrace. An utter disgrace. And we have just sat by and watched this happen. And because, you remember, the week before last, I mean, we saw silver futures hit $50. We saw gold, you know, flirting with 1600. I mean, we saw these types of things, but, you know, the CME Group, which is the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, and for all you folks that are unfamiliar with these different exchanges, well, I don't have the time to, you know, sit here and be your economics teacher, but they, you know, conveniently upped their requirements for margin accounts twice last week, not just once, twice for metals. And this is what caused the free fall in the metals market, but it's coming back. Just like I anticipated, and the reason I say it's coming back is because there's no way that this monetary policy that America is continuing to, you know, embrace wholeheartedly is going to continue to sustain itself. And you're going to have countless investors and countless different people that are going to be out here trying to hedge against this kind of inflation. And not to mention, if you looked at any of your news media as of late, MSNBC, Fox, whoever's your goddamn mainstream news media, mainstream social outlet. These people, every time you cut to commercial, no matter what news media channel that is 24-hour news, no matter what it is, there's always a gold commercial, isn't there? Huh? There's always a gold commercial. There's always this. There's always that. That just shows you there's an accumulation. It's going to continue to be accumulation. That's why I'm telling people right now, you know, just because we saw this pullback doesn't mean that, oh, we're going to see, you know, pullbacks in the markets. It's coming back. It came back today. It came back today. Look at copper futures. They're up $7.85, an increase of 1.97% in copper futures. Gold today is up $21.80, an increase of 1.46%, closing out today at $1,513.40 per troy ounce of gold. Today, silver went up 7.53%. Let me repeat that goddamn figure again. It went up 7.53% today, an increase of $2.65, closing out today at $37.94 per troy ounce of silver. And in my opinion, I think that we're going to continue to see increases in these metals once again. I mean, you know, unless our monetary policy severely curbs itself for the fiscally responsible, which, you know, I don't foresee any time in the near future, we're going to continue to see these types of hedges against these industrial and precious metals. Let's go to livestock. Cattle futures cattle futures are down 75 cents. Cattle feeder futures are down 22 cents. And lean hogs, for all you fat jelly asses, I'd like to shove a couple of ham bones down your hole. They are up 32 cents today. And that, my friends, is the market for your ass. All right? Thank you very much for tuning in with me. Once again, folks, I'd like for everybody to please retweet the broadcast, go to the social networking sites. We have a whole bunch of buttons. Yeah, you see those little buttons right there underneath the player, you know, the Facebook thumbs up button, the little Twitter tweet this button, you know, the share this button, the email this button. Use and abuse those buttons, baby, and spread the word about the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. I mean, let everybody know. Spread it around like goddamn wildfire. All right? And go out there and let everybody know what's going on, all right? Anyway, 646-652-4869. I want to take your calls. We just went through the markets. Not to mention, we talked about the commodities buybacks in the markets. I want to talk about something different since we're talking about business. Apple Computers. That's right. Apple Computers has become the most valuable brand in the world. Yeah. I mean, it's the biggest company in the world at this point in time. Apple Computers. Can you believe this crap? The market capitalization of their stock is $320 billion, all right? Can you believe it? Can you believe this crap? Huh? $320 billion market cap, for Christ's sake, man. Have you seen their stock price? What is it, $330, $320, whatever the hell it is? I don't know. I don't care. But in my personal opinion, I think that it's just purely on hype, you know? I mean, what's really unfortunate is that, you know, every time that Apple puts out one of these little hardware devices, it's always primitive in comparison to what's available on the market. I mean, there's always higher processor speeds. There's always higher accessibility to RAM. There's always better, you know, the only thing that Apple banks on is that they monopolize every single piece of hardware that's in their goddamn PC or whatever computing device they have. I mean, everything that has been produced internally, externally, software, they produce it. I mean, you know, if you're going to be an Apple customer, you are going to sit out there and have to purchase everything from Apple. You understand? And how does Apple have any kind of advantage over this? Well, because their little system is so well calibrated because they monopolize all the internal workings of the PC or the electronic widget, for Christ's sake. And this is what they bank on. That's why they put out, you know, inferior technology, in my personal opinion, you know? I mean, in my personal opinion, I think that you can go out here and build yourself a better computer, or you can go out here and get yourself a better one on the market, and you're not exclusive to windblows either. If you're one of these people that are like, oh, I'm not a PC person,
I think that's stupid.
Well, you don't have to go and buy Winblows as an operating system. Operating systems are coming out the woodwork. And as a matter of fact, if you look in the open source community, and if you happen to be one of these so-called programmers or wannabes, you can actually redefine what an operating system is based upon your computing needs. But, of course, that's up to you. That's up to the amount of knowledge that you have into the computing realm. And that's why I'm saying everybody here needs to realize that just because Apple is the most valuable brand in the world doesn't mean that it has the best technology in the world, folks, all right? This is what the misconception was with Sony PlayStation. Just because Sony was able to shit out a couple of good gaming systems that hooked up a couple of, millions of fat losers that just sat around and got their thumbs bruised playing this garbage. People just assume that Sony, since they're building electronics, since they're building this and that, that they are somehow a safe company, that they know technology, that they're advanced on any kind of network systems, the whole nine yards, all right? And look what happened. I mean, look at what happened, for Christ's sake. Anyway, I want to hear from you, 646-652-4869. Apple Computers becomes the most valuable brand in the world. They have surpassed Google, they have surpassed Walmart. I mean, this is the most valuable brand in the world, for Christ's sake. And I don't think that the longevity is going to last very much longer. I mean, I don't know about you, but, I'm surprised that Steve Jobs is still alive. Can you believe this? Now, look, I'm not wishing death upon Steve Jobs. I mean, he's an innovator. He's a capitalist. I mean, if you read about this man's story, he single-handedly took Steve Wozniak's concept of a personal computer and catapulted into the, multi-billion-dollar success that it is today. But my particular criticism is that once Steve Jobs is dead, and let me tell you, I'm really surprised that he's lived this long. Have you known many people with pancreatic cancer that live like 4 or 5 years after they're diagnosed? I mean, can you believe this? Huh? I mean, can somebody explain how this works? I mean, Patrick Swayze, man. Patrick Swayze was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. That poor son of a bitch was dead within 8-9 months. All right? Bill Hicks was one of the most unbelievable comedians of all time. Diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, the guy was dead within, 6-7 months. This is why I'm saying, what in the blue hell is keeping Steve Jobs alive, for Christ's sake? And the problem is that what's keeping Steve Jobs alive is the same thing that's keeping Apple Computers alive, for Christ's sake. Anyway, 646-652-4869. Let's take some callers here. We've got 111 on the horn. What's going on? You're taking too long, you milky liquor. Money Man, what's going on?
Hey, man, how's it going?
What's going on, man?
Not much. I was listening to your show on Friday. It was about the slut walk, I think.
Yeah, the slut walk. Yeah, we were talking about that. Believe it or not, it was supposed to take part Saturday in Boston. And over 2,000 sluts went out there and, showed their tits and ass and demanded in protest to be called a slut. So I don't know if women want to be called sluts now or filthy whores or whatever they want to be called now, but this is a degradation of women. This was supposed to be a protest in opposition to degradation of women, and here you've got, a filthy, disgusting, dish rag whores taking to the street out in Boston. And not only that, they're organizing it here where I'm at, in Austin, Texas. They're organizing it all over the world. They're sitting over here trying to promote the idea that how a woman wants to be called a slut now. And it's just unbelievable. But go ahead. I'm sorry, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, man. Well, I was just going to say, I really don't agree with the whole Muslim religion, but at the same time, their countries would never allow this to happen.
Well, religious countries are you speaking of wouldn't allow this to happen?
Yeah, like Muslim countries would never allow this to happen.
Well, the thing about Muslim countries, though, is they take it to the extreme, for Christ's sake.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, they want to put their women in beekeeper suits, You know, they want to throw them in some goddamn, you know, fully, you know, burqa, you know, and the only thing that they want to... Hey, man, yeah, turn down your radio there. But the only thing that they want to be able to do is just show off, like, a foot of their woman out there in Islam. And look, I'm not against women going out and becoming capitalist. All right? I'm not some, you know, a sexist asshole as all these jerks that flap their fat Cheeto-stained fingers on the keyboard try to portray me to be. I am not a sexist, all right? As a matter of fact, I am trying to promote womanhood, you know, and protect it, for Christ's sake, because it is being threatened by its own self. I mean, look at these women out here. They're going out in Boston, Massachusetts, this past Saturday. Over 2,000 sluts! Over 2,000 dirty dishrag whore sluts took to the street, scantily clad, showing, you know, a cleavage and having ass cheeks come out of their damn shorts for the right to be called a goddamn slut. Un-freaking-believable, all right? Un-freaking-believable. And you know who this really hurts the most? And I really feel for this. Is the chicks that aren't, you know, given these natural curvatures that's being promoted in entertainment. You know what I mean? The women that aren't promiscuous, that aren't showing off skin, that aren't showing off tits and ass, that actually have intellectual curiosity, women that actually have something mental and intellectual to contribute to society, they are being overlooked because these bimbos out here that are participating in the society that we live in, all they have to do is, you know, wink a little bit at some hard leg or, you know, show some tits and ass. And before you know it, these bimbos are just conveniently going all the way to the top without the mental capacity, without the competency, just because, oh, look at me. I'm a filthy, disgusting whore that looks good in a nice short skirt. You know, it's disgusting, isn't it, Money? It's disgusting. Don't tell me you assholes made some kind of a switchboard about me, all right? I mean, seriously, I don't want that. That's the last thing I need is some assholes calling up, you know, prank calling, making switchboards out of me, making me look like more of a jagoff. Oh, Jesus Christ. Don't tell me that you made a switchboard out of me, you damn limey piece of garbage.
I didn't, man. I didn't really.
If we were in some communist, you know, society. Spermy the cat. Spermy the freaking cat.
Are you kidding me? I'm like, get him
off! You idiot sitting over here making switchboards of my goddamn voice, you sorry sacks of crap. Are you kidding me? You're sitting over here making switchboards of me, you morons. Let me tell you something right now. You better cease and assist those goddamn switchboards. You need to cease and assist those goddamn YouTube videos. You need to cease and assist making me look like an idiot. I mean, don't you understand that I do this show because I am as serious as a goddamn heart attack? Don't you understand that? I mean, I'm trying to sit out here and relay information for people that can actually advance their lives. And here I've got these communist agitators. Yeah, communist agitators over here trying to disrupt my show for what? I have no idea. I mean, they think that they're actually promoting their little stupid communist dumbass cause. But what they don't realize is they don't even know what communism is. They're a bunch of just, you know, imbecilic assholes that were sold this political romantic idea that if you fall in line with this dumbass communist idealism, that you are going to, you know, have a house in the sky and a Cadillac in every driveway and all this other nonsense. Well, look, I'm going to give you a link, folks. I'm going to give you a link to what communism can get you, all right? Nothing more than a cult of personality, and communism has made humanity look like imbeciles, all right? Take a look at this. Look at this link right there. Look, keep pulling. I'm going to post this damn thing. Take a look. look at that link. That's a blog that I posted today on www.capitalistarmy.com. Capitalistarmy.com. And let me tell you something. You need to take a look at that, and you need to see for yourself what the hell communism does. I mean, communism is the most disgusting, disgraceful ideology ever, ever to hit the face of this goddamn earth. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. Click that link, for Christ's sake. I'm not kidding. Click it up. It's the blog I did today. And no, it's not a virus, you morons, all right? As a matter of fact, let me kick some idiot out here. Syphilitic meek, you stupid moron. Get this idiot out of here. Get out! Get out! Get out! Anyway, check out that link. 646-652-4869. Let's take some more callers. We got Afro-American on the horn here. What's going on? Get that stupid hermaphrodite crap off my... Get that hermaphrodite crap off my goddamn radio show! Get out of here! You know, and that's another thing. You know, how in the hell are you idiots worshiping this disgusting, filthy-looking bimbo called Lady Gaga, who, you know, is obviously got a hermaphrodite penis? I mean, you know, it's all over the internet. I mean, we've seen it, you know? I mean, you know, you got a hermaphrodite penis, you know what I'm saying? I mean, at least that's what I've seen. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know, but, I mean, give me a break. And you idiots are buying it up like lab rats running the food pellets, for Christ's sake. And, you know, Jesus Christ, you have no shame, my God damn it. I mean, that's what hits me right here. Hits me in the goddamn heart. And you idiots don't care, for Christ's sake. Anyway. This is too early in the show to be going into, you know what I'm saying? This is just too early in the show to be, you know, getting into this kind of nonsense. You know, it's just, you disgusting pieces of crap out there, you know that? Anyway, before I got disrupted by these Milky Lickers who were prank calling, and it's obvious it's either left-wing, liberal, or communist agitators, or it's, you know, homosexuals that are pissed off because, you know, I don't want oral copulation between two men across the street from an elementary school protected by the First Amendment. You know, it's either or, you know? It's either or! Anyway, let's continue on, shall we? We were talking about Apple being the most valuable company in the world, surpassing Google, surpassing Walmart, for Christ's sake. $320 billion, with a B, billion-dollar market cap, for Christ's sake. I mean, good God, you can't mess with it, man. You can't mess with it, for Christ's sake. Anyway, I'm going to move on to another subject matter because this is something that I was touching on last week, and we're going to continue touching on it because it's afflicting America. I'm talking about the Mississippi River cresting because of large amounts of rain that have just drenched the South and, you know, the Mid-East, Midwest type of area. You know, just consistent rain, downpours, hail, tornadoes, just unbelievable. Unbelievable amount of devastation and, you know, floods that are going to be afflicted, particularly in the town of Memphis, Tennessee. And let me tell you, you know, this is just, you know, an unbelievable display of what's going on here in this earth and how the earth is just afflicting, you know, just unbelievable natural disasters towards, you know, those of us that live on this planet. You know, and in my personal opinion, I just think that it's not a coincidence that we're seeing these types of, you know, abnormal natural disasters, abnormal atmospheric disturbances, abnormal earthquakes, tsunamis, so on and so forth. And you have all these people on this planet that, you know, aren't contributing to the progress of humanity, aren't contributing to the progress of the earth, Instead, they're being detriments. They're being detriments by turning perfectly good food into shit, and that is the contribution that they contribute to this world. You know? I mean, you got to think. I mean, you know, a lot of these people who believe that just because they're born and they're breathing, they deserve food. They deserve, you know, housing. They deserve this. They deserve. You don't deserve a goddamn thing. I mean, you get what you put in. And all you people who sit over here and say, oh, that's not fair, Ghost. It's not fair that the Poe in America can't be fat asses anymore. It ain't fair that the Poe in America can do that. Hey, let me tell you something. Life ain't fair, asshole, all right? Why don't you tell that to all the animals in the food chain right now that are being eaten up by those above them on the food chain? Why don't you tell them that, oh, life, you know, we need to save you. It's garbage. It's garbage, you know? There's way too many loser people being saved on this planet. Way too many idiots that don't have any kind of contribution, no type of intellectual curiosity, nothing. Nothing. And yet, unfortunately, we have to sit here and continue to buy this political romanticism that, oh, every human life is God's special creature. Oh, yeah, okay, yeah, sure. Every human life is God's special creature. Yeah, okay. Give me a break. The only people that should be able to continue on to sustain themselves are those that take the opportunities that are allowed to them in capitalism, that are open to everybody in capitalism, and take them and use them to make their lives better and make this world better. But instead, what are they doing? They're sitting on their fat asses. They're smoking dope all day, watching cartoons, eating cheese balls and mozzarella sticks. You know? It's a disgrace. It's an utter disgrace. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. Talking about the residents of Memphis, Tennessee, bracing for a flood after the Mississippi River crests. Of course, you know, our thoughts and prayers go out to those folks, and, you know, hopefully your thoughts and prayers are also going out to them. I want to hear from you. Let's take some calls here. All right, we got 612. What's going on? That stupid idiot. 818, you're on the horn.
Is this a Krusty Krab?
Jesus Christ, how many times do you have to call up here? Your mother's got crustaceans on her uterus pipe, all right, buddy? Maybe you should put your head up there and, you know, take a good whiff of a bad period. Get him off, for Christ's sake. This idiot is off of here. 909, you're on the horn.
Hey, I just want to say that Apple sucks, and they only get money because they sell things at, like, outrageous prices. Like, you can just make...
Oh, you know, they just sell things like, and, you know, like, and, you know, like...
Well, what's your alternative to capitalism there, like, you know, fruity-ass little chicken-eating corn boy? I mean, what's your alternative instead of sounding like, you know, Greg Louganis' gay lover?
Oh, but that is messed up. You know what I'm saying? That's messed up.
You know, well, you know, you want to know why you're saying, oh, that's messed up. You know what I'm saying? You want to know why you're saying that? Because you can't say anything else. You have no personality. The extent of what you were doing just came out of your mouth, and you're trying to conjure up something to sputter out of your goddamn, you know, little suck hole, and you can't do it. You can't do it. And now all you're trying to do is trying to buy yourself time from making yourself look like an idiot from all the people that are listening to you, 909, and this is the best you can come up with. You see, this is why you don't like capitalism, because you're a loser. You can't learn. You're incompetent. You know, were you special ed? I'm sure you were special ed. Mommy gave you, tit feeding up until 10 years old, the whole nine yards. And this is it. I mean, you know, can you come up with something better? What's your alternative, 909?
What do you mean by my alternative?
Here we go again. You know, here we go again. What do you mean by my alternative? I mean, this is America, folks. I'm not kidding you. I don't ask these people to call up and fake this nonsense. This is the real America. This is the American youth out here, a bunch of bamboozled assholes that don't know their ass from their elbow. And I kid you not, this idiot's probably in college. Are you in college, 909? I bet you money you're in college. Are you in college?
No, I'm not.
Oh, yeah? Well, what are you doing for a living?
I go to school.
Yeah, that's what I... Oh, what are you? Are you in high school?
Yeah.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying? This is what I'm talking about right here. This is public education at its finest. Some high school snot-nosed kid that's, you know, capitalism sucks, like, you know, because, you know, everything's overpriced, like, and, you know, like, this is America. This is it right here. I mean, this is a waste of human life at this point in time, and you could tell he's, like, at least a senior in high school. If he hasn't learned anything up to this point, this is going to be a waste for the next 50 to 60 years. And who's going to support this loser, huh? Who's going to support this loser? Yeah, maybe Mammy will support this, you know, sentence fragment sputtering piece of garbage maybe for another 20 years. But once she croaks, who else is going to support this piece of crap? I mean, listen to him. He can't even conjure up his own ideas. He can't even communicate. 909, I mean, you have anything to say for yourself, for Christ's sake? I just handed your manhood to you in a goddamn platter. What, do you have something to say for yourself?
Not really, no.
Yeah, of course you don't. You want to know why you don't? Because you should blame your mammy for that, you know? Because I can tell by the lack of testicular fortitude and the lack of, you know, fighting back for your integrity shows to me that you were raised by some single mother that should have Ike Turner conjured up and give her a goddamn Tina Turner beatdown for raising such a useless, non-communicative dumbass like yourself. And the only thing that you could come up with is calling me up and saying, oh, yeah, you know, like, you know, capitalism overprices things and it's not right. Here I am, I'm asking you, well, what is your alternative?
And, you know, well, I don't know what you mean.
Now I'm asking you, what do you have to say for yourself? And you're like, nothing. I mean, are you not ashamed, for Christ's sake? I mean, are you not ashamed that you're a pathetic waste and that I just called you out? I mean, I hope that these words are stabbing your goddamn psyche, you know, like a switchblade to the gut. And I hope that right now all these thoughts are going into your mind and you're internalizing in yourself what exactly you are. Why don't you ask yourself that question there, 909? What am I? And you'll come to realize that I'm just nothing more than some mindless idiot that is following whatever I'm told. Oh, TV tells me I need to act like Fruit Bowl. I'll act like Fruit Bowl. Oh, school tells me I only have to learn to answer multiple choice questions. Oh, I do that. I do it good. I mean, do you have anything else to say for yourself, 909? I mean, good God. I mean, you know, I can't believe you're still on the line, for Christ's sake. I would have hung up while I still had a ball left. You're sitting over here still on the line. What do you have to say for yourself?
When I do multiple choice problems, I solve it before I do it. I'm not stupid.
Oh, yeah. Oh, let's give him a hand, shall we? Oh, let's just give the man a hand. Hey, look, I solve it before I answer. I mean, give me a break. I mean, do you understand how stupid multiple choice tests are, folks? All right? They only give them four answers to bubble in or circle. That's 25% chance, even if they're idiots, of them getting it right. I mean, are you kidding me? I mean, look, 909, screw the way you're answering questions. I'm asking you about you, 909. I mean, when you look in the mirror, what do you see in the mirror? What do you see whenever, every time you wake up and have to, you know, comb that bedhead? I'm sure you're one of these fruity asses that sport bedhead, or you got emo hair, or one of these other little fruity ass old trends out here. Whenever you're fixing your goddamn little stupid mop, what exactly are you thinking of inside of your head? I mean, what thoughts are going through your head?
What the hell am I going to do at school today?
And that's it? You know, that's it? What am I going to do at school? What grade are you in?
Like, I don't know.
What grade are you in?
I'm a freshman.
You're a freshman? Oh, well, no kidding. Well, you know, how in the hell can you sit over here and call me up
and try to say that, oh, you know, dude, like, you know, the only thing that I know is, like, capitalism, it causes the prices to go up to everything, like some fruity ass, all right? And now that I'm calling you up, man, I am giving you a goddamn verbal anal raping with no Vaseline, and all you're doing is like, dude, I don't know what to say. I'm stupid. And
I mean, are you crying? Is this boy crying, for Christ's sake?
Crying? Why would
I be crying? I mean, do you have any kind of integrity for yourself? Well, why don't you speak for yourself, for Christ's sake? I'm demoralizing your goddamn manhood, and look at you. You're not saying shit. I mean, is there a father in your picture? Honestly, is there a father there?
Yeah.
Yeah, where is he at?
In the den.
What?
He's in the den.
He's in the den? Why don't you let me talk to him? I want to talk to him and tell him what type of fruity-ass crap popped out of his nutsack. And instead of being on his fat ass in the den, maybe he should be going out there throwing a football with you every now and then. How about that? Huh? Maybe you should go out there to the driving range and hit a couple of golf balls with your ass or something. Maybe go to the goddamn, take you out to eat or something, for Christ's sake. No, instead, you're out here calling the True Capitalist Radio broadcast, sitting over here saying, oh, yeah, you know, capitalism, it's you, meh, meh, meh. Anyway, that's enough of this idiot kid, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ, he's crying his ass off, for Christ. He doesn't know what to say, and it's no coincidence. Get this stupid idiot. I can get him off. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is number to call. I'm sorry that you all had to see that, folks, but you see the kind of garbage that I get? This is America. This is the America that I have to, you know, continue to walk around in, for Christ's sake. I can't even go to the damn supermarket without these stupid, dumbass scumbags looking at my goddamn basket, looking at all the damn T-bone steaks, looking at all the things that I buy because I can afford it. They're looking at me like I just farted on their Sunday dress or something because I am purchasing my own goods, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ, it makes me so sick to my stomach. Jesus Christ, you know what? I need a drink. Anybody got any goddamn beer? More beer! Yeah, we got a beer here, as a matter of fact. You know, because, you know, we had a, you know, was it Cinco de Mayo recently, you can tell that the stores all across Austin, Texas are trying to liquidate all the excess Mexican beer that they got on their shelves. So I got myself a Sol. Yeah, you know, Mexican beer imported out of Moctezuma. And it's bottled, for Christ's sake. So let me go ahead and open this goddamn bottle here so we can get some beer going on. I'm getting a little pissed. But let's go ahead and open this damn beer. Yeah! Woo! That's what I'm talking about, baby. That's what I'm talking about. As a matter of fact, this is a post-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And, you know, I know there's a lot of people that are listening in right now that missed yesterday's spontaneous special broadcast on the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. I usually do not broadcast on the weekends. You know, the traditional schedule is Monday through Friday, 4 to 7 p.m., Central Standard Time. I like to call it Texas time, boy. And I think that a lot of people, you know, just were robbed of the live event that was conducted yesterday. I mean, you were robbed, you know, unbelievably robbed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go ahead and, you know, give you a little taste of what we were celebrating yesterday. Because remember, yesterday was the anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio. That's right. You heard me say it. The anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio. Woo! And I want you to have a little taste of it, all right? All of you Milky Lickers, especially you bimbos, you single mothers out here who shit out about 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 kids from 3 or 4, 5, 6, 8 different fathers out here, and that you want so much props, you know? You want somebody to give you, like, you know, some kind of a goddamn award because you're doing what you're supposed to do, you stupid skankosaurus. Do you understand what I'm saying? I mean, nobody should be getting props because they're doing what they're supposed to do. And that's what Mother's Day did yesterday. That's what Mother's Day did. It gave the opportunity for all these disgusting, filthy bimbos who had children with some idiot who looked good in a leather jacket that they met at last call for alcohol at their local alcoholic dispensary. And lo and behold, they shitted out a kid, for Christ's sake. And we're supposed to be like, oh, look, she's a mother. Oh, shut up. It's an utter disgrace. And let me tell you something. We celebrated, once again, the anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio Broadcast. And once again, I want to give you a little taste of it. I want to give you a little taste of what we were doing yesterday. It was the anti-Mother's Day edition. And if you weren't here, well, you need to follow me on Twitter, for Christ's sake. Follow me on Twitter. That's, you would have been the first to know that I was doing a spontaneous broadcast. And once again, the Twitter name to follow is Ghost Politics. Right there. You see it on the screen? Ghost Politics is the name to follow, baby. Anyway, let me give everybody out here who missed yesterday, episode number 82, if you missed the anti-Mother's Day edition, here's a little bit of taste for you, Milky Lickers. Here's a little taste. Here, hey, engineer, throw on that track that we played yesterday, engineer. Throw it on.
Your mom's a whore. Your mom's a whore, she sucks cocks at the dollar store. Your mom's a skank, your mom's a skank, she licked my balls and gave me a yank. Your mom's a trick, your mom's a trick, she eats vaginas and she swallows dicks. Your mom's a coos, your mom's a coos, she fucks the Muslims and sucks the Jews. Your mom's a bitch, your mom's a bitch, she left me with a nasty itch. Your mom's a slut, your mom's a slut, she likes cucumbers up her butt. Your mom's a hooker, she's not a looker. Always complaining how her puss is aching,
which is weird because she's a whore.
I've got her number and a big cucumber. All that is left now is sex with the fat cow. It's sex with the fat cow. It's sex with the fat cow. It's sex with your mom. Your mom's a whore. Your mom's a whore. She sucks cocks at the dollar store. Your mom's a skank. Your mom's a skank. She licked my balls and gave me a yank. Your mom's a trick. Your mom's a trick. She eats vaginas and swallows dicks. Your mom's a coos. Your mom's a coos. She fucks the Muslims and she sucks the Jews. Your mom's a bitch. Your mom's a bitch. She left me with a fucking itch. Your mom's a slut. Your mom's a slut. She likes cucumbers up her butt. She likes cucumbers up her butt. She likes cucumbers up her butt. She likes them up her butt. You trust fun cunt.
You're listening to Ghost on True Capitalist Radio. True Capitalist Radio.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, baby. You're listening to True Capitalist Radio, and that right there was a little taste of what we did yesterday on the broadcast on the spontaneous anti-Mother's Day edition of True Capitalist Radio. And I hope that you all appreciated it, for Christ's sake. You understand what I'm saying? Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. Before we got sidetracked by all that, we were supposed to be talking about Memphis bracing for flooding after the Mississippi River crests. And, we're trying to have our thoughts and prayers go out to those folks that are out there that are going to bear the brunt of this particular natural disaster. But then we got interrupted by a bunch of internet butt stalkers who continuously prank call me. They continuously harass my show because I am trying to spread the capitalist ideology throughout the world. Anyway, I want to hear from you. 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. Let's take some more callers. We've got Ashton Martin. What's going on?
Roma, Roma.
Yeah, shut up, all right? Shut your stupid hole with that disgusting song. Why is everybody such a Lady Gaga fan, for Christ's sake? She's got a hermaphrodite penis. I mean, Jesus Christ. Anyway, we've got a Dallas Stars fan. What's up?
How's it going on?
Man, we can barely hear you. Why don't you, you know, get yourself a better internet connection? We got Melissa. What's going on?
Hey, man. Got a couple things to say.
Go for it.
All right. I had to live in Austin for several months, and I was staying at an extended stay hotel. And I met so many families that were caught in Katrina, and they had moved to Austin because there are so many jobs in Austin. They paid their way. They stayed in the hotel for a week or less so they could get a job and find a place to live. I saw it happen. I was there months. Two, I want to agree with you on the capitalism. I was a honor roll student, sixth in my class. I thought I was pretty smart. And I got to college, and at 19, met my longtime boyfriend, who was 30, who was a big-time capitalist. And he did speak very rudely to me, and it made me cry, but it also made me think. And I never looked back. Now I'm a mother of three with a fantastic husband who's just like me. And that's what we teach our children. Three boys.
Well, you know, I'm glad to hear it, because let me tell you something right now. I know there's a lot of people who are critical of capitalists because we're such realists, especially as unadulterated capitalists. I mean, we're such realists. We throw things on the table because, you know, most people are living in la-la land. You know what I'm saying? I mean, most people just don't want to hear reality. Yeah, I mean, they just want to, you know, sit over here and live in their goddamn idea of what life is. And, you know, once somebody contradicts their perceptions, they don't want to hear it. Now, I'm not giving any kudos to the guy that, you know, made you cry, the guy that, you know, was really harsh to you, that sort of thing. I'm not justifying that in any regard. But one thing that you have to understand, though, is that if you're going to interpret life as it is, that's one thing that is a prerequisite of being a capitalist, you know? And, you know, what kind of things are you teaching your children?
Well, they do get, the school is pretty good, but they get into this, you know, environmentalists and government should take care of people. And we say no. And we work with their homework. And I've written so many letters on their homework saying, I'm not going to have them answer these questions. They're ridiculous.
And not to mention that, you know, a lot of these questions that are being, you know, put forth in the testing systems are actually, you know, geared towards suggesting ideas into the delicate minds of children. Not to mention that, you know, instead of public education actually teaching children substance-based knowledge, they put more of an emphasis on things like political correctness. And things like, oh, we can't have prayer in school, and, oh, we can't, you know, just these, you know, stupid, ridiculous concepts that have nothing to do with actually progressing the knowledge of the youth of America. And what's really unfortunate is that this is the effect, you know, what you're hearing on the internet, all the prank callers, all the youth-based imbeciles that are calling up right now, this is the consequence of this. They don't understand how to think critically. They don't understand how to interpret reality in cognitive reasoning. You know? And that's my opinion, don't you think?
Thinking. Learning how to do critical thinking. And, you know, I've done it my whole life. It changed my life at 19. And I thought I was a critical thinker in high school. But I really learned a lot in college and did very well in college because of it. And I was at a very liberal college.
What college was that?
University of Oregon.
Oh, yeah, that sounds like a liberal college. Right? Isn't one of those party schools, that sort of thing?
No, a little bit. I mean, it's in Oregon. It's just the land. It's where all the hippies of Berkeley went to. It's very hippie. It's very hippie. But
go ahead.
No, I want my children to think critically. And so far, they seem to be doing so. And my husband feels exactly the same way, which is nice. We parent exactly the same way. And it's incredibly, incredibly important.
You know, that's good to hear, Melissa, man. And I thank you for calling up and giving us those nice words of encouragement. And not to mention that, you're out here showing us that, hey, look, we don't have to be dependent on Big Brother government. We don't have to wait in bread lines. We don't have to do these types of things and embrace this simplistic life that government is trying to shove down our faces. We can be capitalist. I mean, we can define our own destiny. We can, put our own limits on our own life through the ideology of capitalism, And it makes me sick to my stomach to hear these dumbasses call up and say, oh, yeah, communism is so great. Meh, meh, meh. It's imbecilic. Anyway, I want to thank you, Melissa, for calling up, man. It was a great, great insight there. Another subject matter that I want to get into is Pakistan. Believe it or not, the U.S. must ask Pakistan for permission to interview the wives of Osama bin Laden. Can you believe this crap? Yeah, I'm not joking. That, here you've got Pakistan trying to flex nuts over here, trying to, sit over here and say that we got to ask their permission so that we can interview the wives of bin Laden. What the hell's going on with the Pakistanis? We've given them over $20 billion with a B, worth of American capital since 9/11, and these idiots have the audacity to sit over here and say, oh, yes, you would have to ask her permission so that you can interview the bin Laden. Why? Yeah, shut up! Just shut your stinking smelly hole! I mean, us as Americans, we're taking this? We're taking this crap? Is this supposed to be acceptable here? For Christ's sake? Jesus Christ! I mean, you even have that asshole, Pervez Musharraf, sitting over here saying, oh, it's not right that the American people came into the Pakistani area. Shut up! Just shut your stinking hole! You were housing bin Laden! Well, I mean, although I haven't seen any pictures of death of bin Laden, I would like to see the hole in the head. I would like to see the pictures of him, lying on the floor bleeding. I would like to see these things, but, unfortunately, according to our government, we can't handle it. Oh, my God, you can't handle it. Jesus Christ, this is the same country that, YouTubes the reactions of two girls in one cup, for Christ's sake. I mean, that sick-ass, disgusting depravity of humanity is being exposed out here. Why can't we see some dumbass with a hole in his head? Let me tell you something right now. I want to see it. And, I understand that, America is so hyper-patriotic at this point in time. But I believe it when I see it, man. I want to see a picture of this man with a hole in his head. Did you see the damn footage that they've released of this guy? Some idiot in a gray beard, with a goddamn blanket over himself, oh, yes, I'm looking at myself on TV. I mean, speech outtakes, for Christ's sake. I mean, what is this, Al-Qaeda bloopers, for Christ's sake? I mean, all we needed was a Benny Hill soundtrack, a Benny Hill music bed underneath the goddamn videos, and it would have been a goddamn joke, because it's a joke. It's an utter joke. I mean, I want to see the goddamn pictures, and the government is going to sit over here and see how many of us believe it, until they actually have to produce some evidence. I'm sorry. I'm not a conspiracy theorist, folks. I'm not one of these idiots that are out here, you know, touting all this Alex Jones, David Icke garbage. All right, but I want to see. I want to believe it when I see it. All right, I want to see the goddamn pictures of Osama bin Laden dead. Anyway, 646-652-4869. And then this dumbass country of Pakistan has the audacity to sit over here and say, you have to ask that permission so that you can talk to the bin Laden wives. You have to ask that permission. Yeah, yeah, shove it up your ass. All right? Let's take some calls here. We got Googies. What's going on, Googies?
I guess. Let me explain. I'm going to kick your ass. Loser! You're a loser! Are you feeling sorry for yourself? Well, you should be, because you are dirt! You make me sick, you big baby!
Is this, somebody from the new military? Is this it?
No.
Is this how they teach you to talk? They teach you to, like, okay, since we can no longer, beat the living hell out of the goddamn recruits anymore, you got to talk to them in a stern yet fruity-ass fashion, you know? You got to talk to them in a stern, fruity-ass fashion as if you have just been castrated and you have no balls, you know? Shut up, all right? Talk with a pair of balls, for Christ's sake. Get this idiot. Get him up! Let's go take a call. Mexican guy. What's going on, Mexican guy?
Fuck you, Texas, and fuck you, Lone Star Beer. Fuck that fucking Alamo and fucking Lone Star.
Stupid sack of crap. Get this here. Get him off. Don't sit over here and besmirch Texas, boy. All of you haters out there that are sitting over here that continue to sit over here and, oh, yeah, I'm going to play a little song that disrespects Texas. Meh. I mean, you people never been to Texas. You wouldn't have the balls to come out here to Texas and spit that out of your stinking suck hole. You know it and I know it. You silly bastards. We're supposed to be talking about how Pakistan is telling the United States of America how we need to ask their permission before we can talk to the bin Laden wives, for Christ's sake. All right? Now, let me tell you something. All you sacks of crap in here that are flapping your fat Dorito-stained fingers on the keyboard talking garbage about Texas, I mean, come down here to Texas, you sorry sack of crap, and say that crap. All right? Go and amplify that crap. Yell that crap out here in Texas and sit up your asses. Don't get your asses beat. Anyway, I'm sorry, folks. I'm sorry I'm getting upset here, man, but look at these assholes. I mean, this is the type of crap I got to deal with on a consistent basis when I do this broadcast. I mean, internet butt-stalking ass clowns. Look, I'm gonna warn you guys one more time. Do not, and I repeat, do not disrespect, besmirch the integrity of the great state of Texas. All right? Do not besmirch the great state of Texas. All right, boy? Anyway, we've got Laura Wood on the horn. What's going on, Laura?
How many numbers does this idiot have? I mean, I'm shooting pearls here, and these people, this is how they repay me.
Can we all get along? Shantae. You stupid sack of crap.
I can't believe that you idiots actually made a goddamn soundboard of me, for Christ's sake. I'm just sick of show that crap over there. It's disgraceful, man. I'm sitting over here doing this goddamn broadcast on a consistent basis. Hey, look at these people. They're making jackasses out of me. They're making jackasses out of me, for Christ's sake. It's disrespectful, man.
Let me tell you, sorry sacks of crap, something. I don't want to hear any more of this crap, all right? Especially these, you know, YouTube videos that make me look like an idiot. Now I've got soundboards, and I can only imagine what you idiots are going to do with those. You know, you're probably just going to call people, and they're going to think it's me. And, I mean, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. I mean, you know, it's just stupid, man. This is stupid! I mean, I'm a capitalist! I'm a capitalist! And I deserve the respect accorded that goddamn title! I'm a capitalist! Goddamn head hurts. You're making my head hurt! Let me calm down here, folks. I gotta take it. Where's the beer? Where's the beer? Oh, here's the beer. Oh. Jesus Christ. I mean, look at what you're doing to me here, man! I hope that you idiots have a goddamn soul! Let me have another drink of this crap. Jesus Christ. Let me get there. Where did I put the damn mic? I don't even know where I put this stupid freaking... Stupid mic, for Christ's sake. Look, to all the fans that are out there that listen to my show, you know, I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? I'm really sorry that you're witnessing this kind of crap. You know, this is the kind of crap that I've got to put up with, folks. I mean, I don't make this crap up, man. Look, we were talking about how Pakistan is telling the United States that we have to ask their permission so that we can, talk to the Bin Laden wives, for Christ's sake. I mean, that's what we have to do, you know? As a matter of fact, I'm out of beer. Where's another beer? Where's another beer here? Oh, we got a beer right here. You got another bottle of Soul going on over here. Yeah, you're damn right. Look, I just finished a damn whole bottle of beer because of you idiots. You know what I'm saying? I mean, here my goddamn head's hurting. I'm probably on the verge of a goddamn stroke, and you idiots could care less. Look at you people. Look at you people. You don't give a crap. Milky-looking piece of garbage. Anyway, we're talking about Pakistan telling the United States that they have to ask permission to talk to Osama bin Laden's wives, for Christ's sake. And I just think it's a bunch of malarkey. It's stupid. It's ridiculous. And I want to hear what you think. 805, what's up?
Oh, Ghost, you make me so horny.
You stupid internet fuck stalker. Get him off my goddamn switchboard! 718, what's your excuse?
Well, hey, Ghost, hey, hold on, I got it turned up. Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, what's going on, man?
Oh, not much. A while back you played this band called Computer Magic.
Yeah.
Yeah, actually, I like them a lot, and I was wondering if you could play them again later today. If you want.
What up?
I mean, if you want to play them, because I'm actually friends with them. And then, you know, if you play them, I'll let them know that you play them on the show. I'd be pretty cool, you know.
Yeah, yeah, no problem. Maybe I will, man. All right, thanks for calling, bro. Wait a minute. I mean, is that Goofy Bowman? Hey, it's a member of the Capitalist Army, man. We got to put him through. We got Goofy Bone. Just give her a bone. What's going on, man?
Oh, man, Ghost. Luckily, I went to work today, but I'm fucking hungover. Damn Cinco de Mayo. And happy late Cinco de Mayo to everybody out there. San Jose got torn to pieces by these stupid little rioters on Cinco de Mayo, and it ruined the whole weekend. We had cops at every block doing checkpoints. We had walking horse cops. We had everything. Nobody could party. Everybody had house parties this weekend. It was wonderful. And I wanted to touch up because, you know, I heard some rumors because I do have some terrorist friends. The deal was that whoever hit Osama bin Laden, because he had a kidney disease or something like that. Well, anyways, the deal was whoever hit him, and when he died from kidney disease, Osama bin Laden said to whoever hit him that you could call and claim my body and claim the money. So now one of my Muslim friends told me that those two brothers called in to the United States. United States went ahead and did their own little thing, saying that they went in there and killed him when he was already dead. They killed the brothers, they killed whoever else, and as you can see, nobody got that $25 million reward for him. As you can see, no, who'd the check go out to, Ghost? You know,
well,
I mean?
You know, that is one of the subjects that have been evasive by our government amongst a whole bunch of things. We've been getting mixed signals from our government. At first, we were told that it was a heavy firefight. The next thing we heard that, you know, he went out with a goddamn, Kalashnikov or something. The next thing we hear that, you know, he threw his wife in front of a Navy SEAL and begged for forgiveness. I mean, the whole nine yards. I mean, you know, what's the truth?
I believe my Muslim friends because, you know, they know things. And, you know, if a guy has a rocket launcher right underneath his bed, I mean, he means business. But, they told me that the United States screwed those two brothers because those brothers were going to claim him saying, hey, we have his body because he already died. But yet that's why they're not showing no picture, no autopsy picture because or any picture because he was already dead when they got him. And
they already had his body there, and they were just trying to deliver the body and what?
They said that that the brothers called the United States and said, hey, we have his body, you know, we have his body, and they wanted the reward. Well, anyways, it took them quite a while before the United States even reacted on it. Then they went in and did their little phony little escapade to try to make the people of the world believe that the Navy SEALs had a big, huge gunfight when only three men, well, I believe it was three men that were fighting and only two of them were armed. I mean, come on. What kind of big gunfight is that? I've been on the streets. We've had so many gun wars on the streets when cops would come like 45, 50 minutes later. You know what I mean? There'd be kids dead. One of my friends had his brains blown out right in front of me. I mean, you know, I've been into, you know, a gun war fight. You know, these guys didn't even see no action. They went in there, kicked the door, shot two people, and then they went in there and got Osama bin Laden's body. They shot the – and then another thing, Ghost, if they had the nerve to take the body, how come they didn't take the wife?
You know, that's another good point. I mean – I don't understand why Pakistan, first of all, is announcing that we have to get their permission to interview the wives, but you're absolutely right. Why couldn't we just take the wives with bin Laden? You know, it's a good point. I have no idea. Of course, they're going to give us some bureaucratic answer like, oh, well, it would have caused, an international uproar or what, so on and so forth.
No,
so, yeah,
we give Pakistan billions upon billions of dollars, and they still have that piece of shit Sandlot that looks like from Star Wars, The New Hope, where Luke grew up on. I mean, that's what their land looks like. It's just nothing but dunes out there. And we give them billions of dollars, Ghost. What the hell do they do with that damn money? Show me a list.
I have no idea. I mean, you know, it seems like most of the population is living in a goddamn pissing ground out there, in my personal opinion. So I have no idea. I have no freaking idea, you know. And I hear where you're coming from there, Goofy Bone. As a matter of fact, as soon as you started saying this, the damn lines have blown up. We've got a whole bunch of people calling in. Let's go ahead and, take some of these callers, shall we? Who else we got? We got Maddest Hatter. What's going on, Maddest Hatter? No, you're taking too long. We got the Capitalist. What's going on?
Fuck you, Texas, and fuck you, Lone.
Yeah, shove it up your ass, all right? Shove it up your ass! All right, we got 111. What's up?
Hello?
No, you're taking too long, all right? Stop playing with your Peter Popper. 111, you're on the air.
Ghost?
What up?
Ghost, you're an unhealthy closet homosexual rapist who attempts to hide his communist beliefs to no avail. All of your listeners know that you love Lady Gaga and crave Howard Stern's penis, and we believe that you should just do a bit.
I mean, wait, did you write that down, for Christ's sake? I mean, you don't even sound like you're genuinely saying that from your heart. You sound like some idiot that, you know, took all night, you know, like it was homework to, you know, say this kind of crap. Why don't you, you know, come up with some original ideas that come out of your stupid noggin? How about that?
Why don't you do a barrel roll and show us your toolbox?
Yeah, there we go again. You see, not another idea. As a matter of fact, you're using a meme that's like, you know, 5 years old. Barrel roll, barrel roll, barrel roll. I mean, that's a goddamn old meme, for Christ's sake. Get this idiot off. Get him off! Probably another freshman, you know? Another freshman, for Christ's sake. Anyway, we got Nikki in the house here. She's supposed to be, you know, our, resident bimbo here in the chat room. What's going on, Nikki? Give me a break. You don't even have the internet bandwidth to upload that Rickroll, for Christ's sake. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, what are you on, net zero, for Christ's sake? What, are you getting a free internet connection? What's going on here? Jesus Christ, this is what I'm getting here, man. This is all I get all day. Anyway, let me move on to another subject matter. How about that? You know, maybe that'll change the theme. What I want to talk about now is how Christians and Muslims are continuing to clash in Egypt. That's right. We touched on this yesterday in the anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist radio broadcast. You know, when our American mainstream media were having a circle jerk over this post-Katrina riot job that was happening out there in Egypt, I was here on the True Capitalist radio broadcast calling it for what it was, and it was a goddamn, you know, a horrible display of disgusting heathens. You know, that's what the Egyptian so-called revolution was. I mean, you know, you compare what's happening in Syria to what's happening in what happened in Egypt in the so-called revolution. I mean, you know, Syrians aren't destroying buildings. They're not destroying businesses. They're not going into people's homes and pillaging their goods and raping their women. And they're not doing that. All right? That's not what they're doing. Unfortunately, they're being killed by the totalitarian government of Bashar al-Assad in Syria. But, you know, Egypt, they utilized this so-called uprising in Egypt to, you know, be a whole bunch of wild Jihudis that are just going out and, you know, causing havoc for the sake of causing havoc, for Christ's sake. I mean, it was the Rodney King riots on steroids, you know? And now, and let me tell you, the person that is single-handedly responsible for this is this asshole Google executive, Whale Ghanem, all right? Whale Ghanem. And, of course, folks, please tweet this asshole and tell him what kind of a waste of human life that he is. There's his Twitter name right there, all right? You tell him I said that he's got blood on his hands. Twitter that asshole and say he's got blood on his hands, and Egypt should hold him accountable for all the destabilization that is happening in that country today. He single-handedly, he himself, single-handedly manipulated the primitive civilization of Egypt with the technology of Facebook and Twitter. And believe it or not, these people, when they saw Twitters from this idiot saying,
take to the streets. We got to go against Mubarak, go to the streets. When they saw Facebook little outburst, saying, oh, you go to the streets, oh, yes. These idiots actually went and did it. And that's why I'm saying this idiot has blood on his hands. Well, let me explain, okay, what's happening to this guy. Whale gone him, okay? And tweet that asshole, and you tell him I said. You tell him I said that he's got blood on his hands. But he's being treated as if he's the goddamn, you know, Che Guevara of modern history. I mean, he's being put on a goddamn pedestal to the point where it's just almost star fucking, for lack of a better term, and excuse my French. This guy has been named Time Magazine's most influential person in the world, okay? Not to mention that he just signed a book deal, all right? He just signed a book deal to explain and outline in detailed form how he was able to manipulate the primitive civilization of Egypt with technology. As a matter of fact, the book is prematurely called Revolution 2.0. And I'm not joking. I mean, you know, how can anybody follow somebody who is obviously out to be a hypocrite? You know, here's a guy, oh, I am a revolutionary. Yes, I am a Will Ghanem. I am a revolutionary. I wasn't raised in Egypt. I wasn't even brought up in Egypt, but I am going to live in Egypt, and I am going to utilize my position as a Google executive to go out and cause an uprising in Egypt against Mubarak. And that's what he did. That's exactly what he did. It's a disgrace, man. It really is a disgrace. And that's why I'm saying, anybody, you know, here's Whale Ghanem's Twitter address, and you tell him I said he's got blood on his hands. And the Egyptian, whatever governing body that's governing Egypt should hold this man accountable. All right? But now we've got violence in Egypt. It's going back to the haywire that, you know, spawned this whole ouster of Mubarak. I mean, you've got Christians and Muslims killing each other. They're killing each other out there in Egypt. Yeah, thanks, Whale Ghanem. Yeah, it's so great to, you know, that you inspired such, you know, revolutionary activity. Meanwhile, you're going to go to the big Times most influential dinner, and you're going to go to the gala. You just signed yourself a $1 million book deal. Meanwhile, the people in Egypt are suffering because of your stupid irresponsibility, Whale Ghanem. Anyway, there's his goddamn Twitter address once again, and you tell him I said he's got blood on his goddamn hands, and Egypt should hold him accountable. Let me tell you something. If any one of us attempted to do what Whale Ghanem did in Egypt, we would be thrown in jail for treason, if not executed. This guy's given the most influential person of the world status by Time Magazine. He's given a $1 million book deal, for Christ's sake. That son of a bitch has got blood on his hands, and that's all there is to it. Old Whale Ghanem. And I want to hear from you. 646-652-4869. We got 727 on the horn. What's up, man?
Hey, Gus. Hey,
what's up, man? Good to hear from you.
I got a cheap microphone today. I hope you can hear me. And that guy, when his book comes out, he ought to let that CBS News anchor interview him, huh? One that got raped after the revolution was successful?
Yeah, he should have Lara Logan interview him and see, you know, how she interprets Whale Ghanem's enthusiasm to this disgusting revolution. It's not even a revolution. It was a riot fest. It was a disgrace to humanity, and why our media covered it as if it was some beautiful contribution to human enlightenment is ridiculous, man. It was ridiculous. And now look at them. They're in disorder. borderline chaos. There's bombings in the Suez Canal. I mean, you know, you got all kinds of disorder happening. Christians and Muslims are clashing in Egypt. And yet, Wael Ghanem, the man who manipulated this, you know, emerging market, yet primitive in the regard of understanding the technological innovations that we have taken advantage of through all these years, no, he manipulated these people into, you know, rabble-rousing them into this, you know, riot-like disorder. And now that, you know, all the demands were met to all this disorder and chaos that was happening in Egypt, Mubarak is gone, they got a new government, so on and so forth. Now they're still unhappy, they're still killing each other, the violence has gotten even worse. And Wael Ghanem, what, he's going to become a millionaire author and he's going to be, you know, go down in history as some goddamn revolutionary thinker? Bullcrap, man.
Right. You got two choices in the majority of the same thing's going to happen in Libya. You've got two choices over in that part of the neck of the woods. You've got a secular dictator, or you can have a murderous terrorist theocracy. And the secular dictators have worked for a long time very successfully. And so that's going to be the, you know, the track mark of this president, because by the time he's done with this presidency, even gets elected another 4 years, this planet is going to have more firestorms going on than when he came into office.
And let me tell you, I mean, the world is destabilizing as we speak. I mean, you already had India, you know, touting that, hey, we always knew this about Pakistan, and they're saber rattling into believing that they should have justification in going in and invading Pakistan. They have a long history of two wars that India has won over the disputed region of Kashmir. You've got the destabilization of the entire Middle East. The entire Middle East is destabilized. Not to mention, you know, I haven't really covered this because I'm waiting to see what is transpiring, but you have Hamas and Fatah, which is the two opposition groups in Palestine, actually coming together in a unified fashion, and, you know, putting all the bad blood aside to, you know, try to make Palestine an actual state. And, you know, Israel, you know, seems to be threatened by this. So I don't know what's going to happen between these two factions at this point in time. You've got the destabilization reaching into Bahrain. Bahrain is still, you know, jailing people, still killing people. You've got, what is it, that, I mean, you got so many countries out here under destabilization. Yes, Syria, obviously Syria, but what's that? The where Bin Laden was born. What was it? Jesus Christ, Yemen.
Yeah.
Yemen is also under you know, a horrific destabilization process. I mean, the whole goddamn Middle East is under, you know, threat of possible mindless uprising similar to that of Egypt. Not to mention we've got leftists that are still agitating the emerging markets in South America, you know, and you've got, I mean, it's just so much destabilization in the world, man. I thought that by this time we would have been able to, you know, bring ourselves in some sort of peace cycle, given the fact that the 90s seem so much different than today. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I fully understand why Pakistan has taken a hard line with the United States, because they've been on the brink of being taken over by the you know, the Taliban faction of that country forever. I mean, they've been that guy's been walking a tightrope as it's been. I mean, they don't have control of the whole, you know, western part of the country as it is. So, you know, I mean, it sounds disrespectful, and it is, and all that other stuff. It's wrong. We give money, all that. But I mean, they're literally they could be right in the mix with these other countries in a heartbeat with that government.
Yeah, you know, and that is true. I mean, there has been, you know, attempts at destabilization out there in Pakistan. There's been bombings. There's been Taliban attacks. There's been other things of that nature, and I can agree with you on that. But at the same time, I mean, you know, Pakistan has to make a concerted effort to, you know, enlighten their people. I mean, you know, they are more worried about keeping their autocratic system in power and, you know, them ruling over their subjects as opposed to, you know, bringing in their people into modernity. And if you look at the people that are marching in the street in Pakistan, man, they don't look like they're living great lives. You know what I'm saying?
All right. Hey, I got one more thing. Here's a conspiracy theory, but you ever think maybe the reason they don't want to release the picture of Bin Laden is because it's evidence? You remember how many times they wanted to drag George Bush over to The Hague and Dick Cheney to The Hague, and they want him indicted on international war crimes for waterboarding prisoners down there and other things like that? I mean, is there any international law that justifies a point-blank execution of somebody without a trial or even a military trial or without anything?
You know, that's a good point. I mean, given the fact that Obama has embraced the international institutionalism of the United Nations, NATO, and other international institutions, that's a very good point. Of him not releasing the video or the pictures of Bin Laden based upon future people in politics when he's long gone and retired, trying to make a name for themselves and utilizing these international institutions to call these people back for war crimes. We've seen it time and time again. I mean, we've seen it from these, when they put Pinochet.
Right.
When he was an old bastard up, I mean, you know, they will do this. This is a very good point that you brought up here that since Obama, you know, he campaigned on being an international embracing president.
Well,
go ahead.
I mean, they're against military. I mean, they want civil trials in the United States for terrorists down at Gitmo. And so we go from granting people who are shooting guns at us civilian trials in America, and now they're okay with point blank execution of somebody who is not in an act. I mean, if he's a prisoner of war, then when are you allowed to point blank execute people who are prisoner of war? I mean, there's no precedent for if they point blank execute him because he didn't want him back and he didn't want to deal with where to put him and all that stuff. A point blank execution of an unarmed person, I don't care if it's Hitler or whatever. I mean, all the Nazis, they got to go to Nuremberg, then they were hung or shot or whatever. There's no precedent if it was a point blank execution. There's no international precedent for that. And for them to release a photo, they could tell if it was a point blank execution from a photo. I don't know. I mean, hey, you're gonna live by the left. You want to live by the leftist. You're gonna die by the leftist rule. And these guys were—they want to lock Dick Cheney up for every single thing under the sun for the last 8 years. And now they run around, drop in a house without permission of another country, walk in and point blank execute somebody. And somehow that's legal, but waterboarding somebody who was firing upon our soldiers is not.
You know, that was a very good piece of insight, man. I mean, you know, that's a very good point, given the fact that this administration is so encompassing of this international institution. We may never see the photos based upon that. You're absolutely right. I mean, it is contradicting evidence to what has been put out by the government. The government has said that, Bin Laden had Kalashnikov or, you know, he the propensity of him getting violent was, you know, so near and dear. But other reports, are coming out. Go ahead.
Yeah, they changed the story three or four times. The first thing was that he was armed, then he wasn't armed, then he was reaching for a gun, he wasn't reaching for a gun. And then they just said, oh, we're not going to talk about it anymore. And now we're going to do the victory lap, and they don't want to talk about what happened in that house because I think it was a point-blank execution because they thought they would kill him in a firefight or whatever, and next thing you know, he's not in a firefight. He's sitting on the floor on his knees. He don't have any weapon around, and they've got orders to kill him and not bring him back because, Obama doesn't want to deal, what to do with him. So,
not to mention that Pakistani press, according to the interviews that they have done with Bin Laden's wives, according to the Pakistani press, he was begging for his life. I mean, you know, he was saying, it's not me, it's not me. I mean, this is coming out of the Pakistani press. You can look it up for yourself. Apparently he went out like a chump. And, you know, of course, the SEAL teams, you know, when you're in the midst of action, given the history of all this, terrorism scenario related to this character, they took it possibly upon themselves to execution-style murder this guy. And since Obama has been such a champion of international institutionalism, It just makes perfect sense to not release the photos so that just in case after Obama is either unelected or is no longer president anymore, he can't, as a private citizen, be tried in The Hague as a war criminal, just as you said they're trying to do for George W. Bush and Dick Cheney, for Christ's sake. They're not just trying to try Dick Cheney in The Hague. They're trying to try him here in the Justice Department. Here, Eric Holder's trying to find something so that we can throw in Dick Cheney. You know, here right. They are in complete contradiction to what they're trying to represent. You're absolutely right.
Right. And what would have happened if, when they found Saddam Hussein in that hole in the ground, what if they just dragged him out of the hole and shot him point blank on his knees? How would that went over? George Bush did that instead of a trial and then hanging him.
You're absolutely right, man, and you know, this makes perfect sense, man, and, you know, I never even really, took it that literal, but we have to take it that literal.
Right.
We have to take it that literal because these idiots actually believe in this international law. It's stupid.
Absolutely. Take care, Ghost. I got to run.
No problem, man. Thanks for giving us that insight, man. Once again, that's an avid caller, avid listener, and obviously a member of the True Capitalist Army. Once again, folks, if you are unfamiliar with the only social networking site that is dedicated to capitalists throughout the world, well, by God, we are looking for a few men and women to join the Capitalist Army. That's right, www.capitalistarmy.com. We're looking for a few good men and women that are out there that are going to, you know, exchange ideas. Who want to amplify the idea of capitalism throughout the world, www.capitalistarmy.com. Here's the link. Go out there. We want you, baby. Capitalistarmy.com. But anyway, that was a good, point that the last caller brought up, that what if Barack Obama doesn't want to release these photos because potentially that is evidence to, put him in trial at The Hague. That's just, pretty good analysis there. 646-652-4869. We're talking about, before we got sidetracked with that, we were talking about how Christians and Muslims continue to clash in Egypt, while Wael Ghanem, the ass clown that inspired this whole riot session and chaos in Egypt, is, going to galas held by Time Magazine because he's named Time Magazine Most Influential Ass Clown of the Year. Not to mention, he just signed himself a multi-million-dollar book deal, for his classic book that he's going to produce called Revolution 2.1. All right, I mean, no kidding. I mean, Bobo, thanks for tweeting that guy. Everybody, tweet this idiot. I'm not joking. Tweet that stupid asshole and tell him that I said. That me, I said that he's got goddamn blood on his hands, for Christ's sake. Any one of us did what this idiot did, we would be put in prison, and we'd be, if we were lucky, we had life in prison. But most likely, we'd be executed for treason. You know it, and I know it. Let me take another swig here. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is a number to call here. Once again, we're talking about Wael Ghanem, kicking back, living lavish on, the chaos he's inspired. I want to hear about you. 646-652-4869. We got the Republican on the horn. What's up? Stupid Lady Gaga hermaphrodite penis-sucking idiot. 404, you're on the horn.
Yo, what's going on, Ghost?
What's up, man?
Yeah, I was thinking about these people in Egypt, and it's like there was – I'm just remembering something. There was a lady that was part of the revolution, or whatever you want to call it, on The Daily Show with Jon Stewart a while back. I don't know, maybe 2 weeks ago. And she was bragging about how they've done this and that and how they're so part of this whole revolution. And it's, we've done so good. And then I remember thinking – This was days after that after the military took over, that they made protesting illegal. She was pretending that they made so much progress, and right then and there, protesting had been made illegal.
Yeah, I mean, this is why I keep saying that, these people that claim to be such revolutionaries and all they're doing is rabble rousing the masses into being chaotic, anarchic, mindless, primitive morons. You know, these are the individuals that are just trying, they have a motive in some way, whether it's power, whether it's money. You have to figure it out. Whale got them. And obviously the woman that you saw interview, these people want notoriety, they want money, they want book deals, they want to be shown in the international stage as some kind of revolutionary. But let's be honest. I mean, look, I don't mean to say anything bad when I say that the Egyptian country is a primitive country. I mean, I'm not trying to say anything bad other than the fact that they weren't introduced into modernity. They were an emerging market, emerging from the third world status that plagued that country for so long into a first world status based upon foreign investment, based upon the tourism industry that, gave them hundreds of millions of dollars, each year, so on and so forth. But now, because of this revolution or this riot fest, nobody wants to go and visit Egypt. Now you've got civil unrest, civil disorder. Just like you said, once the military took power, they outlawed public protests, for Christ's sake. And now, since they're no longer rabble-rousing against the government, they're, sitting over here taking in this this opportunity of rabble-rousing and riots to clash against the Coptics, which are the Christians in Egypt. The Muslims are attacking them. The Coptics are protesting. It's a disgraceful situation. And yet we have Time magazine celebrating this idiot who inspired this crap, which is Whale Ghanem, with Time magazine's most influential idiot of the year and getting book deals. And what I'd like to know is, what do the people of Egypt think about this crap? You know what I mean?
Yeah. I don't know how they feel. I don't know.
I mean, it's sad. That these people, they were bamboozled by this Google executive, mind you. He was a Google executive. And, he manipulated these people into, causing Egypt into chaotic unrest. And now what? He's already left Egypt. He's no longer in Egypt anymore. And, he's out there, signing book deals and, ready to go to Time magazine galas, for Christ's sake. I mean, is that a true revolutionary? I mean, that's all I'm asking the Egyptian people. Is that a real revolutionary?
No, it's not. Wait, I had a couple of comments on the whole Osama bin Laden thing. I feel like this whole thing is, I'm kidding, but it feels like it's kind of like a test for the people, what everyone in this country will believe. It's like, well, they'll believe it straight if Obama says it, and the media pretty much, goes along with it. And then someone online was saying, well, Obama's talked about it. That proves it. And I went back and said, and Bush also said there are WMDs in Iraq. That really proved it.
Let me tell you why everybody's falling hook, line, and sinker just based upon the president's word. Is because you got all these liberals and all these idiots, remember, back in 2008, that were, chomping at the bits, shoving this propaganda down our throats, saying all the dumb mantras, yes, we can, baby, yes, we can, hope and change, baby, and all this other crap. And they've been pretty much let down since the president has taken office. I mean, the president bailed out everybody that he was supposed to be the enemy against. He gave all this money to Goldman Sachs, stimulus package too. I mean, on and on and on. I mean, he got into another war in the Middle East. He just went back on everything that he ever said. Now that they have this substance, because believe it or not, the idea of Barack Obama catching Osama bin Laden gives the Barack Obama campaign political capital so that they can go out and cash on these masses of people that actually believe this nonsense, that were still high on that 2008 hysteria of hope and change. Now this re-energizes that for them to go out for 2012 and say, yeah, baby, come on. I mean, it's been great, baby. I know that it's been a little bit of junkyard America. I know that we sitting out here, we got more people unemployed. We got a lot of people collecting government cheese. We got a lot of people collecting all this and that, baby. But let me break it down to you like that. 4 more years, baby. four more years is what we need, baby. And let me tell you, he called Osama bin Laden, baby. I mean, I know that you're sitting over here talking all this yin-yang, baby, that you ain't making all this money, but he called bin Laden, baby. And that's what you need to recognize. You know what I'm saying? I think you need to recognize, baby. As a matter of fact, you need to recognize that over 35% of the American public are collecting, not the American public, let me rephrase that, baby. 35% of the American economy is comprised of government entitlements, baby. 35% of the American economy is comprised of government entitlements, baby. You want to know why? You want to know why that is? You want to know why that is, baby? Because we've turned into junkyard America, baby. Oh, yeah. Welcome to junkyard America, baby. Come on down. Anyway, and that's the way it is, man. I don't mean to be making light of it, 404, but that's just the way it is. I want to thank you for calling and your concern, man. But this is just the way it is, you know. And us as capitalists, us as people who listen and are in tune with what the news really is, we have to keep blogging. We got to keep chatting. We got to do what we have to do to spread the word. I'm not joking, man. This internet communication thing really works. And that's why I'm advocating everybody who's listening within the sound of my voice, all right, at least get a blog. At least get some kind of venue where you can actually put some substance-based thoughts and processes down, especially if you're a capitalist. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. We were talking about how Christians and Muslims continue to clash in Egypt while Whale Ghanem, the ass clown who manipulated the country of Egypt into chaos, strikes million-dollar book deals and, is chilling like an insane villain at the Times Magazine Top Influential People of the Year gala. I want to move on to something else. I want to move on to Iran a little bit because let me tell you something. The revolution in 2009 of the youth of Iran in an attempt to overthrow the Ayatollah, in an attempt to overthrow the Ahmadinejad, it was one inspiring revolution to me. I mean, these people were unarmed. They had no way of actually having an armed resistance against the Iranian revolution, the Iranian guard. And yet they went out there and protested against Iran. They protested against the Ayatollah. They protested against the hypocrisy of theocracy. They protested against these rigged elections, and they went out there and fought. I blogged about this, mind you. I blogged about this, and I showed a video of the suffering and of the sacrifice that those young people in Iran did in hopes of providing a catapult for capitalism, in hopes of providing an opportunity for democracy. And I will never, ever forget those revolutionaries in 2009 in Iran that attempted to overthrow the Ayatollah. And may, fate shine highly upon those souls. But let me tell you something right now. We've got some infighting in Iran, all right? Even though Iran slaughtered its own people to quash its uprising, I mean, why do you think that Syria's Bashar al-Assad is, slaughtering its people? Well, he saw Iran get away with it, so, he figures, hey, I can get away with it too, you know? Well, now there's some infighting in Iran, for Christ's sake. I kid you not. There's some infighting for power. As a matter of fact, the president of Iran, Ahmadinejad, is, trying to be muscled out, out of public perception by supporters of the Ayatollah and the clerical supremacy, which is the leadership of the country. And what conservatives in Iran are saying about Ahmadinejad is that President Ahmadinejad actually conducts himself in black magic and, you know, tries to summon genies to help him, you know, through his endeavors as president of Iran. And as a matter of fact, the reason that this is such a big deal that the Ayatollah's, you know, backers are accusing Ahmadinejad of, conjuring up genies and, utilizing black magic is because it's against Islam. It's against the whole idea of Islam, for Christ's sake. And, you know, there's some power going. There's a power struggle going on. The Ayatollah is afraid that, you know, the secularist system that he created that was a puppet, you know, he thought he could, you know, be able to throw a puppet secularist system to make the people believe that they had some choice when in actuality they don't. It's all in his pocket. And it was revealed to the people in 2009. Now, Ahmadinejad and the system of the government is trying to supersede the power of that of the clerics. I mean, it's so beautiful, man. You know, it's so beautiful to see the Ayatollah, you know, sitting over here having to resort to say that, oh, yes, Ahmadinejad does black magic, for Christ's sake. I mean, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, for Christ's sake? I mean, good God. This is America, for Christ's sake. This is it. This is America. Well, not America. It's actually Iran, for Christ's sake. Anyway, believe it or not, we actually have a representative of the Ayatollah on the horn here. I kid you not, you know, because I was going to be critical of the Ayatollah, the Revolution Guard, well, actually, the Revolutionary Guard is actually part of Ahmadinejad's crew. It's the conservatives that are a part of Iran that actually wanted to be represented on this program once I was critical of Iran. So without any further, we actually have somebody representing, you know, the Ayatollah, you know, in Iran. Without any further ado, Ahmed, are you there, sir? Ahmed?
Who is Al-Azam?
Allah.
Who is Ar-Rahman?
Allah.
Who is Al-Mannan?
Right. You need to understand, all your American people, all the people all over the world, that the Ayatollah is going to continue. And your people don't understand. Because Ahmadinejad wants to sit here and take away the Ayatollah's power, you're not going to do it. The Ayatollah will stay here forever. We have implemented the first Islamic state throughout the world. You know it, and I do. We have implemented it throughout the world. And your people need to realize that the Ayatollah is going to be here forever. Islam is going to be here. A lot of you all need to bow down to the Ayatollah. We control Islam. We are going to control Iraq. We are going to control Syria. We are going to control the whole of the Middle East. There is nothing you can do about it. I have nothing else to say. Wallah Rabbah.
All right, get him off. Get him off. I mean, you heard it right there. You know, the Ayatollah is going to continue to sustain itself. It doesn't matter what's happening, for Christ's sake, and, you know, people are just going to have to deal with it. We're just going to have to deal with this hypocrisy of theocracy out there in Iran. I mean, an utter disgrace, really. It's really an utter disgrace, for Christ's sake. Anyway, you know, I look at these people here in the chat room, for Christ's sake. Look at them. They have no respect for me whatsoever. I'm sitting over here, I mean, Jesus. Christ. I'm shooting pearls here. I'm shooting pearls, and these people are calling me a racist. These people are calling me all kinds of names, for Christ's sake. I mean, Jesus Christ. I mean, I really don't appreciate you people out here spreading these slanderous lies about me. All right, you're spreading slanderous lies about me that I'm some kind of a grand dragon that I'm some kind of a racist when I am a melting pot of friendship, all right? I'm a melting pot of friendship, and I want you to etch that in your simplistic brains, all right? I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be black. I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be Mexican. I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be Oriental, for Christ's sake. All right? I happen to have a whole bunch of friends that happen to be Arab. So don't sit over here and give me this crap, all right? I am not a racist. I'm a melting pot of friendship. Stop spreading that slanderous lie about me. Anyway, we are in the third and final hour of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. And, of course, I am your host, the man they call Ghost. And once again, folks, I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. Please, if you could, retweet the broadcast, all right? Go to the social networks, go to the blogs, go to the forums, and spread it around like goddamn wildfire. And let everybody know that True Capitalist Radio is in effect and in the house, and that we're right here on blogtalkradio.com/ghost, all right? As a matter of fact, if you happen to be bored, if you happen to be just sitting there playing with your Peter Popper, nothing to do, go to blogtalkradio.com/ghost. Once again, blogtalkradio.com/ghost. We got thousands, and I do mean thousands of hours of content of yours truly with all kinds of episodes. We've been doing this show close to 5 years, baby. 5 years we've been doing this broadcast. And we got thousands of hours here. Thousands of hours. You sack of crap. Stop calling me a racist. Stop calling me a goddamn racist, or I'm going to start playing music until the end of the hour. How about that, huh? How about if I play RuPaul all through the goddamn hour, 25, or how about I play Just Give Rebound? How about I play that, huh? You silly bastard. I mean, look at these people. No respect. I get no respect whatsoever, for Christ's sake, from these freaks. No respect whatsoever. I'm shooting pearls. I'm giving people opportunities on how to become capitalists. You know what I mean? I mean, you know, listening to Ghosts is like making freaking money. But what's unfortunate is that these people are too simplistic, too imbecilic, too ridiculously pathetic to understand the words that I am amplifying across this fiber-optically connected world that we call the Internet. Do you understand what I'm saying? I'm not joking, for Christ's sake. I'm not joking. Anyway, once again, I'm a melting pot of friendship, folks. Don't listen to these idiots in the chat room, all right? I am not a racist, all right? I'm not a racist, for Christ's sake. Anyway, before we got sidetracked by all that, we're talking about the power struggle in Iran between the secular, government head of Ahmadinejad, Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, who is the president of Iran, against the Ayatollah, who is the supreme cleric of the entire country out here. And let me tell you something right now. I mean, I love to see this. I love to see infighting amongst bureaucratic systems, you know. Not to mention that you've got conservatives on the side of the Ayatollah in Iran actually claiming that Mahmoud Ahmadinejad is practicing black magic. I mean, this is the kind of political mudslinging that's happening in Iran. They're claiming that Mahmoud Ahmadinejad is out here, you know, practicing black magic, and he's summoning genies, for Christ's sake, like he's Aladdin, you know what I mean? I mean, Jesus Christ, what the hell's going on here? I mean, is this for real? Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call. I want to hear from you, all right? I see a lot of ass clowns up in here flapping their fat, Funyun-stained fingers on the keyboard talking a bunch of malarkey about me. Why don't you get your fat, dimpled cottage cheese ass up off your chair, all right? Get up! Get up off your chair, get to the nearest phone, and give me a goddamn call. Give me a goddamn call. 646-652-4869 is the number to call. Let's take some calls here. We got 337 on the horn. What's your excuse? Hello?
Hey, Ghost.
Hey, what's up, man?
Not too much, man. I made a song about capitalism. I want to see if you would hear it.
All right, go ahead.
Hey, my name is Joe. I'm a racist Catholic. I don't like Mexicans or blacks. I can never relax doing amphetamines. It ain't just my task. I wish I could be like Howard Stern.
Just a second, turn him off! Let me tell you something, Howard Stern, you idiots. All right, if you have a bone to pick with me, you asshole, I mean, why don't you meet me somewhere, Howard Stern, all right? Stop sending these idiots that you use and abuse, and mind you, you don't pay them a goddamn thing other than putting them on the show, all right? They're sitting over here writing songs. They're sitting over here doing all this crap. I mean, why don't you face me mano to mano, Howard Stern? How about that, huh, boy? Huh? I don't give a shit if you're 6'7", you know, bag of bones, for Christ's sake. Let me tell you something right now. I got about a 280-gallon drum of whoop-ass, and I would pour it all over you, you long-haired, wicked wannabe. All right? Sick son of a bitch. Did you hear that, Howard Stern asshole? They even had auto-tunes in that goddamn song. Can you believe that? Auto-tunes! They got a goddamn idiot playing the banjo with auto-tunes, for Christ's sake. You know, I mean, him and T-Pain must be, you know, trying to get a payday, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ. Anyway, who else we got? We got USA. What's going on?
If you don't agree with me, we've got a racist. Let's have a feather bed. You're a racist. And if the gloves don't fit, then the judges.
What is everybody making songs about me now? Is this the next thing that I'm going to have to expect? Huh? Is this the next crap that I'm going to have to take, for Christ's sake? Assholes making songs about me? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding? I mean, damn it, man. Damn it. I mean, people are making songs about me like I'm some sort of jerk off, for Christ's sake. Jesus Christ. Anyway, who else we got? We got USA. What's going on?
If you don't agree with me, we've got a racist. Let's have a fair debate. You're a racist. And if the gloves don't fit, then it's a judgment.
Oh, what is everybody making songs about me now? Is this the next thing that I'm going to have to expect? Huh? Is this the next crap that I'm going to have to take, for Christ's sake? Assholes making songs about me? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding? I mean,
You're listening to Ghost on True Capitalist Radio. True Capitalist Radio.
Yeah, that was a little bit something for you there. We're from America, all right? This is America, for Christ's sake, all right? I know that you idiots want to sit over here and think, oh, America's so damn great, and there's an impossibility for us going down, and meh, meh, meh. I mean, listen to these idiots that are calling up to my show, for Christ's sake. I am not making this crap up. I am not making it up. Anyway, 646-652-4869 is the number to call here. We were talking about how the power struggle between the Ayatollah in Iran and President Ahmadinejad in Iran is getting pretty dirty. The conservatives out there in Iran who back the Ayatollah are blaming and claiming that Ahmadinejad participates in black magic, you know, and, you know, summons genies and that sort of thing. So anyway, we're going to move on to another subject matter. What I want to talk about now is old Bristol Palin. Bristol Palin, that's right, because let me tell you something right now. Her mother was the reason that I turned my back on the conservative movement, all right? If the conservative movement is going to embrace some hypocritical, you know, dumb, imbecilic bimbo as a legitimate candidate for vice president, or even president, for Christ's sake, is a disgrace. I mean, everything that this broad has, you know, projected out of that suckhole of hers has been nothing but sentence fragments written garbage, all right? I mean, that's all there is to it. As a matter of fact, I'm going to take another beer here. Let me get another. Is there more beer up in here? Is there beer? Let's get some beer up in here. There we go. Yeah. Woo! Anyway, let's take some calls here. I want to talk about Bristol Palin. She's getting her own reality show thanks to that whore mother of hers that, you know, is out here touting her ignorant crap. You know, oh, look, it's Sarah Palin. Even though she's dumber than dirt and an ignorant slutbag that probably, you know, shook her ass and winked her eye all the way to the top, it's okay, all right? It's okay. Don't worry about it. We'll forgive this stupid, dirty Eskimo bimbo. It's all right, eh? It's all right. Well, now we've got Bristol Palin, you know, with a new reality show. Not to mention, have you seen Bristol Palin's face recently, for Christ's sake? I mean, good God, she must have went shopping at the same cosmetic surgeon that Octomom got her face done, for Christ's sake. I mean, bleh! I mean, that was a disgrace, you know, and yet, you know, what are the conservatives saying about this, huh? What are the conservatives saying about Bristol Palin, you know, who, you know, had a kid on something that looks good with a hockey stick, you know, going out, moving from the backwoods of Alaska, going down to California and doing a little reality show, huh? Oh, yeah, thanks, Sarah Palin, you stupid slut. You know, thanks a lot for producing such a, you know, a whorebag offspring, all right? Anyway, 646-652-4869. I want to hear from you. What do you think about Sarah Palin's, you know, offspring going out, getting a reality show because, oh, look, my mom's an imbecile. She's the laughing stock of the world, and look at me. I'm going to get myself a goddamn reality show. Sorry. Anyway, 646-652-4869. Let's take some calls. We got 111. What's going on?
Hello.
What up?
Hey, is this the Krusty Krab?
Your mother's got Krusty Krab's upper, you know, used up anal passage, you know, which is kind of loose, by the way, you know. Muzzy, what's up?
Hi, Ghost. How you doing?
How you doing, man?
I just wanted to say something, but first I would like to ask you something about capitalism, if that's cool.
What's up? Go ahead.
Like, what luxuries do you do with the mass amount of money that you have?
Are you kidding me? What don't I do with the luxuries I've got? Are you kidding me? That's what continues keeping me going every single day. I mean, every time I make money, I try to do something that I haven't done before, for Christ's sake. I mean, I know there's a lot of idiots in this chat room, a lot of ass clowns that are out there in the international community trying to claim that I'm some kind of a drunkard. But I'm a goddamn connoisseur. You understand? You notice I'm never drinking the same goddamn thing every day. I'm doing something different every day because I can do that. You know, I can go out and drink, you know, and get my palate exposed to, you know, a whole bunch of different brands of beers and liquors and wines and champagne and that sort of thing. Not to mention that, you know, whenever I travel, which isn't much, I don't really travel too often, but whenever I do travel, I'm chartering Learjets, baby. You understand what I'm saying? I mean, I live in a damn high-rise condominium in Austin, Texas, right off West 6th Street, for Christ's sake, that overlooks the entire city. I mean, you know, whenever I go out and have a cigar outside my porch, for Christ's sake, I can see the entire city of Austin, Texas, and it looks so goddamn beautiful, baby. I love it. And let me tell you, if I wanted to, luckily, I live close enough to everything within my vicinity that I can walk, or if I wanted to, I can go out and take one of these pedicabs or something. But in my personal opinion, I mean, I don't have to use gas anymore, so gas doesn't really affect me. But even if I did, I'd be renting limos. You know, I eat T-bone steaks every day. Me and my wife, we go out to the best restaurants out here in Austin, Texas. Perry Steakhouse, the Italian, I mean, just the whole nine yards. We're doing so much crap, it's just living lavish, baby. I love it. I would not trade it in for anything else, man.
That sounds good, man. But I would just also want to say that I think you're a Texas faggot and your fist just some while he sleeps. My castle's better than your shitty apartment, you cunt.
I can't understand you. Can you try to, you know, slow down your, you know, pussy-whipped accent for a little bit? And try to, you know, speak it a little slower so everybody else can understand what you said there. Can you? Why are you gonna hang up? Why are you gonna hang up, Scottish boy? Come on, or Irish boy, whatever the hell you are. Come on, I wanted to have some fun. I wanted to have some fun with you, for Christ's sake. Hey, engineer, throw on some music because that stupid ass. Throw on some music, engineer. There we go. I wanted to have some fun with you, mate. Look at my head. I'm like a charms here. You know what I'm talking about? Oh, yes, sir. I'm Lord of the Dance now. I'm going to do the Lord of the Dance. That's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm going to do here. Let me go ahead and stomp my feet on the ground here. Oh, yes, that's what I'm doing here. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you're shoving up your arse here. You know what I'm talking about? All right, get it off. Anyway, 646-652-4869. We're talking about Sarah Palin's sweatbag daughter, Bristol Palin, not only getting her own reality show, but she's got herself a new face, for Christ's sake. You know what I mean? You know, she couldn't, you know, stop eating the, you know, whale lard or whatever the hell they're eating out there in Alaska. She couldn't keep off of it, so lo and behold, she got some, you know, fat sucked out of her face and, you know, had her face stretched like a silly putty stretched over your knee, for Christ's sake. I mean, isn't Bristol only like in her early 20s? I mean, isn't this a little young to be, you know, stretching your face out like this? And that's another thing. Why do you bitches think that we like that? Why do you think that we like your face stretched, you know? I mean, have you seen these bimbos nowadays that are trying to flaunt their asses out here with these disgusting huge lips and this stretched face? I mean, they look like burn victims, you know? They look like burn victims, for Christ's sake. They look like a burn in a fire, and they had to have reconstructive surgery so that they could, you know, restructure their face. I mean, you know, is this what, you know, the entertainment industry is trying to force women into believing that we want to bang, huh? I mean, are they trying to force women into believing that, you know, men actually want to see some burn victim face, you know, before they... I mean, it's stupid. It's just utterly pathetic. Utterly stupid. The only reason I bring that up is because, you know, Bristol Palin, I mean, have you seen her latest face, you know? Let me go on. 646-652-4869. We got area code 405. What's up?
Joe, not to mention,
What's up?
Look, I was listening to your show, and I primarily came here to control that window, man. It kind of makes sense. My dad had a radio talk show in San Diego talking about the same kind of stuff you've been talking about.
Well, you know, I'm glad. I mean, you know, your dad's probably right. You know, we should be talking about these types of subject matters, and we should be expanding the idea of capitalism. That's what we should be doing. You know what I mean? And, you know, what you should be understanding is that don't listen to your peers that are in your same age group, because these idiots are out here spending $12 a pop on Mai Tais to get some bimbo that's showing off her cleavage in a bar somewhere to talk to them, for Christ's sake. You know what I mean? I mean, this is America. I mean, they're spending their money on, you know, $500 damn iPhones when they don't even have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of. You know, these idiots can't even make a goddamn down payment on a sandwich, and yet they've got, you know, enough money to continue to get these electronic widgets. You know, they got the, you know, a plasma screen TVs and the whole nine yards. It's disgusting. It's sick. It's stupid. So I understand what you're coming from, son. Let me tell you, and if you do have a father that, you know, is broadcasting as a talk show host out there in San Diego, you tell him to give me a call. Or better yet, won't you tell him to give me a tweet at Ghost Politics. That's the name to follow on Twitter. And we'll have him on here on the True Capitalist Radio broadcast, all right? That's what we'll do. You know, I mean, we need more capitalists. We need more individuals that are out here spreading the word about capitalism. And that's all there is to it. And I know that we're talking about this, you know, stretched-faced Eskimo bimbo, Bristol Palin getting a stupid, dumbass reality show. But, hey, this is America, all right? She wouldn't be getting a reality show if these idiots in America weren't watching this crap. And this is it. This is what we have to, you know, look forward to out here in America. As a matter of fact, give me a beer. Give me a beer, engineer, for Christ's sake. I'm sitting over here suffering, man. Jesus Christ. Let me take a chug of this beer. Anyway, 646-652-4869. Thanks for calling 405. We appreciate it. Anyway, we're talking about Bristol Palin and about her getting not only a face-stretching job, but she's out here getting a new reality show. I want to move on to something else, all right? I want to move on to this new Chaz Bono book. And for you people who don't know who the hell Chaz Bono is, she happens to be Cher's daughter, who, you know, decided that because she could no longer trim down the weight from her fat jelly ass, and, you know, she was so unattractive to the male gender, that she just decided to, you know, turn into a bull-nosed bull dyke to the point where she thought she could actually go and get reconstructive surgery and, I don't know, attach a penis down there. I don't know, but she had the sex change operation, all right? Chaz Bono actually had the sex change operation, and she's out here on this press junket promoting this little book that she wrote in response to her getting a penis put on herself. I kid you not, this is not a joke. All right, I mean, Chaz Bono, which is Chastity Bono, which is the daughter of Cher, all right, believe it or not, you know, she decided that not only was she a bull-nosed bull dyke, she was also a male inside. So she went and had the operation. Believe it or not, she had the operation. I know people are freaking out, like, what, did she grow a penis? I mean, from what I understand, they take the clitoris that's already hanging down there and actually form some kind of a small penis out of that thing. I'm just telling you what I've read and what I've been told. I mean, it's disgusting. It's disgraceful. But now that's what this bimbo is doing, or shim, or whatever you want to call this crap. But the book that Chaz Bono is releasing is about her struggles from making that transition from female to male. And what were the struggles exactly? Well, you know, Chaz, whatever the hell you want to call this, you know, it, all right? Chaz actually had a girlfriend. You know, this is before she actually had the penis put on her, all right? She had a girlfriend, and, you know, they had such a great relationship, according to reports from the book. They had such a great relationship, and, oh, she knew me from inside and out, and she was just so great. And then later on in the book, they talk about how Chaz Bono started taking testosterone, you know? Started, you know, popping testosterone so she could, you know, no longer sound like some goddamn female and, I don't know, try to get some balls to drop from her, you know, uterus pipe. I don't know, but apparently when Chaz Bono started taking these testosterone pills, she started to change. And it started affecting her relationship. And things that Chastity used to like, Chaz, with the new testosterone treatments, didn't like. And it was a new adjustment. It was like getting adjusted to a new person. And, oh, the trials and tribulations of putting a penis on yourself. Oh, good God. I mean, are you kidding me, for Christ's sake? I mean, this disgusting disgrace of Chaz Bono was actually on Don Imus this morning. She's doing a doing a goddamn press junket trying to sell this book about the hard trials and tribulations of being a woman and a bull-nosed bull dyke that wants to have a surgically implanted penis put on your private parts. Oh, my God, it is just so awful, and it's just such a tragedy, and it's just, meh. I mean, are you kidding me? Seriously, are you kidding me? Look, it's one thing to be some bull-nosed bull dyke, all right? It's one thing for you to go out and say, hey, you know, I'm an ugly chick, you know, obviously nobody wants to give me the high hard one, I can't hop on a pogo stick like I want to, like all these other sluts. So, you know, maybe I should start, you know, diving on the carpet in hopes of trying to get my sexual gratification off or something. Okay, I get it, all right, you're a bull dyke, you're out there, you know, you're diving on, toys for twats in hopes of, you know, fulfilling your sexual desires, whatever, all right? But how you can say, okay, now that I am a bull-nosed bull dykes diving on carpets, you know, I got some femi broads diving on mine, how can you somehow jump from that to, oh, yeah, you know what I want now? I want a surgically implanted penis on myself. That's what I want. That's what I need. I need a surgically implanted penis made out of the leftover skin of my clitoris so that I can make myself a whole human being. Oh, Jesus Christ. You know, and she's going out on a press junket for this crap. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. I mean, this is what I'm saying, man. This is what I'm telling you. America is being flushed down the proverbial toilet, and all I'm trying to do, all right, all I'm trying to do is get us back to where we were. I mean, just get us back to the where we were. You know, we used to be the bastions of capitalism, the bastions of freedom. Remember that in the 80s? You know, we it looked like the sky was the limit, for Christ's sake. You know, we were the bastions of capitalism. Now we've become the bastards. We've become the bastards of capitalism, and it's been out of our own free will. Our own free will. I mean, you listen to these idiots that call up all the time. They're like, yeah, I'm collecting government off. I'm collecting money off the government, baby. You understand what I'm saying? That's what I do. I do what I do, baby. You understand? Obama giving me money out of his check, baby. You know? He giving me money out of his check, baby. Yeah! Yeah, Jesus Christ. Anyway, let's take some calls here. We've got Aztec Warrior. What up?
Hey, dude, how's it going?
What's going on, man? Can we all get along?
you're a Mexican. I know you're a Mexican. Admit it. Admit it. You're a Mexican. I'm tired of this crap.
You son of a bitch. Get this in and get him off. Let me tell you something. You idiots out there making soundboards of me better cease and assist from this crap. All right? You better cease and assist. You know, I'm not joking, man. This is not a joke. You better stop using my content to make me look like a jagoff. I'm not joking. All right? I'm not joking. All right? I mean, I'm sitting over here giving people not only opportunity, not only knowledge, not only wisdom, but the insight, you know? And this is the kind of thanks that I get from these idiots, you know? This is the kind of crap. I get soundboards made of me. I got these stupid-ass YouTube videos about me. I've got blogs written about me, about all kinds of slanderous lies. You know, I got emailed by a group of people calling themselves the Wood Chipper Babies. Can you believe this crap? They're actually calling themselves the Wood Chipper Babies, and supposedly in the email that, you know, they want to be recognized because they support my cause, supposedly, but they're calling themselves the Wood Chipper Babies. I mean, give me a break, man. Seriously, man, give me a break. Jesus Christ. Anyway, 646-652-4869. We're supposed to be talking about Chaz Bono up in here. Instead we've got, you know, internet butt stalkers playing soundboards of me. We got idiots playing YouTube clips of me. You know, I mean, it's just disgusting. You know, unbelievably disgusting is what it is, all right? Yeah. People are like, oh, yeah, that's a great band name. You know, my band name is better. If I had a band, and I said this before, it would be Michael J. Fox and the Shakes, all right? And that's all there is to it. Anyway, Milk Chalk, what's going on?
Hello, mate. How are you doing?
How's it going?
Going good.
Shove it up your Australian ass. I can tell that Australian twang. You know, go shove a kangaroo head up your ass, you platypus humping fruit bowl. Let's get another 111. You're on the horn.
Oh, Ghost, I just want to see a toolbox. Can I see a toolbox?
Yeah, I bet you do, you fruity bastard. I bet you do. You know what I mean? 111, you're on the horn.
Hello?
Yeah, what's up?
I think you're racist communist.
Oh, you think I'm a racist communist? Based on what, you idiot? And you're going to hang up.
I think that you're a racist communist.
Silly bastard. 901, what up? Playing these goddamn YouTube videos of me, for Christ's sake, all right? Yeah, I'm just... I'm through with this crap, all right? I mean, I don't do this to be made fun of, all right? I don't do this to be made a jackass out of. You understand what I'm saying? I don't do this to be made fun of, for Christ's sake. I do this to spread the word about the goddamn capitalist movement, about the capitalist ideology. That's why I do it. Makes me sick to my stomach. It just makes me sick. And this crap. Look at this. And you know what makes me sick is that every time, all right, every goddamn time I do this show, and I have a great office, it's Monday, the Consuela, that stupid Mexican, came in here, cleaned up the office, and every time I come in here, these goddamn assholes out here in the damn chat room that are calling me up. They I mean, look at this mess. I mean, look at this mess now, for Christ's sake. Look at this goddamn mess, for Christ's sake. I mean, look at this. Jesus Christ, let me take a... Where's my beer? Where's my goddamn beer?
Here we go. Let me go ahead and take a beer here.
Ah.
Oh, Jesus Christ. All right. Anyway, let's take some more callers here. We're talking about Chaz Bono in her newly surgically attached penis, and she's writing a book about it and writing about the hardships that her and her girlfriend had to endure when she was pumping herself full of testosterone and making changes. You know, she was like Ozzy Osbourne in that one song, right? Like, I'm going through changes. I'm going through changes. I mean, give me a goddamn break, you bimbo. I mean, you know, oh, Jesus Christ. Anyway, 646-652-48. Hey, Herbert, you're on?
Yeah, is this Ghost?
Yeah, what's up?
How old's your son? Does he have muscly arms? Do you like to fist your own son?
What the hell is that? What is this crap?
I'm just asking about your son.
You sick son of a bitch. What are you, some Woody Allen butt-loving pedophile? What's your problem?
Well, I do love children.
Are you kidding? I mean, is this a joke? I mean, is this for real? I mean, what are you, is some pedophile for real, for Christ's sake?
Well, I thought this was a pedophile radio. You're the host.
You silly bastard. Get this thing out. Get him off! I mean, that's the last thing we need is Woody Allen butt-loving pedophiles calling up and saying,
oh, yeah, I like a good boy. I like to put boys on the knees and make them pray. And I want them to pray good, baby. I like for them to get on their knees and squeal like a pig. That's right, baby, squeal like a pig. Squeal like a pig, boy.
I mean, give me a... Oh, Jesus Christ. You know, I'm trying to figure out a reason, you know? I'm trying to figure out a reason why I should even continue this show, you know? I'm just trying to figure out a reason why. I don't even know why I'm doing it. I don't even know why I'm doing this crap. You know what I mean? I mean, you know, I'm sitting over here. I mean, ugh, Jesus Christ. I mean, you know, I'm shooting pearls to you idiots here. You know what I mean? And this is the kind of thing. This is the kind of... Thanks, I get, man. Oh, Jesus Christ! I don't know what else to do for Christ. I don't know. I'm tired. You know, I'm tired. I'm tired. I'm tired. I'm tired. Tired as crap. Oh, you got about 17 minutes, you know, and, you know, I'm just thinking that, you know, maybe I should just throw on some RuPaul, right? Maybe I should throw on some RuPaul. How about I throw on some goddamn RuPaul for your ass? Hey, engineer, throw on some RuPaul for these idiots because, you know, they're pissing me off. Throw on some goddamn RuPaul for these idiots, all right?
I have one thing to say. You better work.
There you go. How you like that, huh? That is just for all you idiots, huh? How you like that, huh? How you like that, huh? You like a little bit of that, huh? You're shaking your little pretty ass? Huh? Yeah, look at these people. Now they're happy, huh? Now they're happy, huh?
Shantae. Shantae.
Oh, man, you all deserve this. That's all I gotta say. You all deserve this right here. If it look good on you, yeah, you like it. You all like it. You know it. Oh, you don't like that one? All right, shut it off, engineer. Shut it off. They don't like that, all right? They want something else. You know, they want something else even fruitier than that. You know, not to even think that there is anything fruitier than that, but they want something fruitier than that. So you got anything else, engineer, up your sleeve? Go ahead and throw something on out there so that you can throw these old fruity bastards in for some kind of a loop. Put something on! Oh, here we go. Yeah, this is something for these fruit bowls out here, huh? Here they are. I mean, these people are dancing to this, engineer. I mean, can you believe this crap? I mean, this is unbelievable. I cannot. Jesus Christ. It's. Screw this crap. Screw it. I'm not going to sit here and continue to broadcast to a bunch of fruity ass bastards that are playing for the pink team that are sitting over here smelling up the whole goddamn room like butt crack. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it, man. I mean, smell it in here, man. Smell it. I mean, it smells like a dirty, shitty, smelly urinal in the middle of a goddamn carnival, for Christ's sake. I mean, look. I mean, it's disgusting. It's disgraceful. Look, people want me to do shout-outs. Go shove it up your ass. I'm not giving anybody a shout-out today. I'm not giving anybody a goddamn shout-out. Go shove it up your clogged-up colon pipes. I'm not giving nobody a shout-out, you piece of crap. Sitting over here, I'm shooting pearls, I'm giving everybody information, giving everybody inside advice. You know what I'm talking about? I'm enlightening people about international relations, the whole nine yards, and this is what I get, man. This is the kind of crap that I get. And I'm not fat, all right? Stop saying I'm fat. I'm not fat. Go ahead and just take a goddamn drink of this crap. Anyway, let me get this goddamn. We'll take a couple more callers here, all right? We're going to take a couple more callers. Let me take a deep breath and try to, keep these idiots from pissing me off. All right? I'm going to try to take a deep breath here. All right. I feel a little better. Everybody, once again, the capitalist army is always looking for a few good men and women that want to join the capitalist army and spread the word about capitalism throughout the world. All right? www.capitalistarmy.com. All right? Go ahead and join it now. Right there, www.capitalistarmy.com. Anyway, let's take some calls here. We got, who we got here? We got Robert Tramp. What's up?
Hello, Ghost. I fucking love you.
Shut up, you stupid UK butt lover. Who else we got? 111, what's up?
Hey, Ghost.
What's up, man?
I think you should just go ahead and suck Howard Stern's penis.
You couldn't even say that with a straight face. You want to know why? Because you're a useless human being. You can't even sputter out a sentence fragment. You can't even sputter out a sentence fragment without screwing up. That's how much of a screw-up you are in life. Don't you know
that? Take a deep breath after you rant.
Huh? Oh, can you say that again there, boy?
You're just mad because you have to take a deep breath after you rant.
Now, shut up. Why don't you surgically extract the goddamn lard that's in your windpipe, for Christ's sake, every time you breathe? I mean, I can tell a fat fuck from a mile away, and that, my friend, is a fatty. All right? Keep eating, fatty! Keep eating, fatty! Anyway, who else we got here? We got 405. What up? You're taking too long, you milky liquor. Get this idiot off. Who else we got? We got Mike Bill. What up, Mike Bill? Are you there?
The Capital Army are total faggots.
We can't understand you with that stupid, dumbass accent you got, for Christ's sake, all right? Take your mouth off the Queen's clitoris and, you know, maybe come back and we'll understand you. Kinetic, what's going on, man?
Howard Stern sucks! Howard Stern sucks!
Yeah, I can agree with that. Howard Stern...
He kicked the crap out of you back in the day anyway, Stern! And he still kicks the crap out of you!
Oh, Jesus Christ. Don't tell me this is another soundboard here, please. You know, come on, man. Come on! I mean, you know, I agree. Don't get me wrong. I like that sound of me saying Howard Stern sucks because he does. He's a piece of garbage. All right? Howard Stern is a piece of garbage, and you can tell him I said that. All right? As a matter of fact, what you should do is you should tweet and email Sirius Radio right now. You should tweet and email Sirius Radio and say, the services of Howard Stern are no longer needed. And if you want me to continue to pay for radio, maybe you should put somebody on the air with some kind of a talent, all right? I mean, not some 60-year-old windbag that's got a wig on his head, bringing in porn stars and, you know, throwing, you know, salami with mayonnaise on their asses, stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, give me a break. I mean, you know, Jesus Christ. Anyway, let me give some shout-outs. I know there's some people out here that want, you know, a couple of shout-outs here. We got One the Pariah, 9009 Kitty, A Bear, A Vanna Eat Poop, Admin J, Alcoholic, Anal, I'm not even going to say the rest, Andy Garcia, Ben Dover, Bobo in the House, Buffy Puffins, Camping Core, Captain Charisma, Creature 151, Donald Weber, Dr. Harry Shipman, we've got Dr. Mitch Henderson, we got Dylan Malnori, what's going on? We got Eat My Poop, shove it up your ass, Eat My Poop, Enzo, we've got, I'm not even going to say it, let's kick that idiot out of here, get him off! We've got Flying in the House. We got Future DNB. What's going on, Future DNB? Let me tell you something right now. The other idiot after Future DNB, kick that idiot out too. Kick him out. Get out. Get him out. And the other guy after that idiot, get him out too. Get him out. Get out. Anyway, we got a whole bunch of guests up in the house, man. Look at all the guests up in here. What's going on to the guests? We got Gems 93 in the place. We got John Brand in the place. We got Josh 11 in the place. We got Jub Jub Joe in the place. We got Keyboard Cat, Leaky Pooper. Oh, Jesus Christ. I mean, good God, with these sick fucking names. I mean, are you kidding me? Jesus Christ, man. MasterCard, Mackie is in the house, all right? Menoman, Jesus Christ, Milk Chalk, what's going on? We got, My Wife Beats Me. Ah, Jesus Christ, I feel bad for you, buddy. Your wife's beating you. Why don't you get your pimp hand strong on that bimbo? We got Nigerian. We got that whore Nikki Owens up in the place. We got Pepe is Nice. Poop Tickler. Jesus Christ. Once again, I mean, these goddamn names, for Christ's sake. Poop Tickler, man. Papa Dot in the place. What's going on, Papa Dot? Good to see you. Rockstar 57. Sir Slicks-a-Lot. Smell My Poop. That's actually a name, folks. I'm not telling you to do it. That's a name. Smell My Poop. This ignorant asshole. We got Spermy the Cat. You know, this asshole. We also have, hey, what's going on? The Strope McAfee in the place. What's going on, Strope? We got
Texas. Oh, man, hold on, hold on. There's some idiot by the name of Texas Sucks. Get him out of here. Get him out! Get out! Get this Texas guy out! Get out! Anyway, we've got the guy, 1337. What's going on, the guy? We got Tom Backhouse, who's spreading slanderous lies about me on Twitter. We've got True O'Gray. All right, we've got Yevgeny Vino Gradoff. What's going on? We got Yoka. What's going on? And we got Debbie Daly in the house. What's going on, for Christ's sake? I mean, you know, what's going on to everybody listening in? And once again, I rely, and not only I, but the capitalist, True Capitalist Radio broadcast relies on you spreading the word about the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. All right? So spread the word on Twitter. Spread the word on Facebook. Spread the word on all the damn social networks, the blogs, the forums, the whole nine yards, and let everybody know that Ghost and True Capitalist Radio broadcasts every Monday through Friday, 4 to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, baby. All right? Central Standard Time. Anyway, we got 4 minutes left. We were supposed to talk a little bit about how the Obama campaign is trying to bank on the gay donors for funds. That's right. They're banking on gay donors to, you know, contribute to the campaign contribution account of Barack Obama, because a lot of the donors that were around in 2008 are a little pissed off at the fact that he completely went against his word and he's no longer going to have, those donors to rely on. So Barack Obama is going out there for the gay donor debate. And another thing I wanted to talk about was yesterday's program, which is a great program, all right? It was an anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast, and I strongly advise you, if you haven't heard it, go back to the archive, all right? Go back to that goddamn archive, blogtalkradio.com/ghost, all right? And take a look at episode number 82 and let everybody know what's going on the anti-Mother's Day edition of the True Capitalist Radio broadcast. Do you understand what I'm saying? Anyway, here it is. There's the website. I want to thank everybody for tuning in. We got 2 minutes left in the broadcast. Please follow me on Twitter, all right? Follow me on Twitter. It's the best opportunity to figure out when I'm conducting any kind of spontaneous broadcast. If I happen to be chatting online, if I happen to be kicking back in the internet community, I will be tweeting it on my Twitter account, and you can kick back with me, break bread with me, chill with me, drink with me. As a matter of fact, cheers to everybody out there who's listening in. Cheers. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm talking about. Anyway, follow me. Ghost Politics is the name to follow, folks. Ghost Politics. All one word, no underscores. And not to mention, folks, there's a whole bunch of buttons underneath these little players that we have here. You know, what you're listening, there's a whole bunch of little buttons, a little Facebook thumbs up button, a little Facebook thumbs up button. We got to tweet this button. We've got to share this button. We got an email button. Use and abuse those buttons, baby. Use and abuse them. All right? Spread the word, for Christ's sake, man. And last but not least, all right? Last but not least, we are looking for a couple of true capitalist men and women that understand the game, that understand what's going on out here. And I would like for you to please join the capitalist army at www.capitalistarmy.com. All right? There it is right there, the only social network meant for capitalists. Here it is right here. Anyway, we got 1 minute left in the program. I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. Once again, follow me on Twitter. All right, man, don't be an ass clown and follow me for 1 minute, and then I make a controversial tweet and you stop following me because, oh, he hurt my feelings. It's not fair that ghosts are here and you made fun of somebody. And meh, 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 meh. Anyway, www.capitalistarmy.com. I want to thank everybody for tuning in with me. I will be here tomorrow, like I am every Monday through Friday, 4 o'clock to 7 p.m. Central Standard Time, Texas time, baby. So mark it down in your calendars and make sure that, any website that has ghost content on it,
you better bookmark it and come back and see us, baby. I'm being here tomorrow just like I am Monday through Friday. Thank you for tuning in with me, folks. I am out of here. Long live the capitalist movement and death to the slut walk. I'm out of here, baby. Yeah.
You've been listening to True Capitalist Radio. The thoughts, views, ideas, comments, and opinions of the host of this show are absolutely his. Catch more live episodes Monday through Friday from 3:30 to 6:30 Central, or check out archive shows at blogtalkradio.com. True Capitalist Radio.
That's it.
Adding the choice of a crispy chicken BLT to Wendy's 4-for-4 is the biggest thing since rappers trying to sing.
I got me out and I sound like a robot.
But do you like the sound of this? Wendy's 4-for-4 now comes with a choice of a junior bacon cheeseburger or a crispy chicken BLT.
From Detroit to Macon, I keep it crisp like bacon.
Both are topped with crispy applewood smoked bacon and come with 4 nuggets, fries, and a Coke for just $4.
Oh, yeah.
At participating Wendy's for a limited time, meal includes small fries and a drink. Not valid in Alaska and Hawaii.